Whoa, whoa, whoa. I can't lean back. Look at this.
Alright, you've made me overcome my fears of.
I'm trying to lean back and there's a short cord.
Do you want
to
swap headphones? This one is a super long one.
Yeah. Yeah, it's important to Davin that the checkers to see his best side.
Exactly.
So we've got Davin on the right.
So who do we have on first? It's Coffee Rex and Scraddles, two very technical foxes, I think. These two players, pretty decent.
Yeah. Any opinion? I think Scraddles is a hot favorite. He's got the experience, he's got the tenure. Coffee Rex, though, talks a lot of, he's an online personality.
Definitely been playing a lot on Netplay. I've played him a couple of times and he's very, very, very strong. Scraddles, haven't played him for a while.
I should have brought a more breathable mask. Mine's kind of hectic. I got the Wizrobe mask.
These masks are a pain. I want one of those like really cool masks with patterns on them. You know the ones?
Yeah.
It's like flowery masks, cloth masks,
My Bloody Valentine mask.
Exactly. Those ones scream value.
Yeah.
These ones, they're just the standard stock
standard. What about a picture of your face?
That'd be a pretty cool mask.
Or like, a picture of...
Just your nose and your lips. It looks like you're not wearing a mask at all. Yeah. That way you can really blend in. But then you might get told off to wear a mask.
Yeah, but then you can trick people. You can say, well, wait till you see this. And you take the mask off. And then they look real stupid.
True.
So we've got Scraddles.
I don't know if this is a real...
What? I think Scraddles is red usually, right?
Yes, yes.
Scraddles
is red.
But I know Coffee Rex likes to play the white vanilla fox.
I think they're in a game right now. Yes, they are.
So what do you like to look for in this matchup, Davin?
I actually don't know how to play this matchup at all. I usually just drill and hope for the best. Drill, look for a shine after that, or just grab. But then when they stop getting hit by drills, then it's...
Yeah, it's hard.
Also, they drill after you do, then it's also very hard. Or they just avoid you.
I feel like Coffee Rex is, how did he not get that edge guard? I looked away as if, you know...
Scraddles gets the first... I think Randall had something to do with it.
Okay.
What do you look for in this matchup, Nick? As a seasoned Fox player.
Well, I was going to say, I feel like Coffee Rex doesn't know how to approach.
I think so too. Coffee Rex's gameplay is a lot about not getting hit as opposed to hitting the opponent. His defensive game is really strong and he does all these really nice baits like Nair dash back or like full up drill dash back, things like that. But I think it works out well in the Fox matchup.
I agree.
Many people have said that the second Fox to act usually does better in this matchup.
Yeah, I mean, people aren't that precise with their movement to be able to, like, pull out.
Yeah.
Dance dashing. Scraddles, though, he's got a wealth of experience.
For sure, Scraddles' been playing for a very long time. Oh, Coffee Rex misses that edge guard. Scraddles gets back on stage.
You gotta hit those, Davin.
Cleans it up, looks like. No, he doesn't! Scraddles is back again and gets the stock.
They're heading for five, Davin.
That's the classic mid-level player.
Yeah.
Just not getting the strong punishes when they need to.
The
not
breathing
his stock out. Exactly.
Oh my god, that's more than five.
Double up smash, 20% each.
You know what I was watching? Mango's highest DPS combos. And there's a lot of that. There's a lot of just like strong move into strong move into shine dare. It's crazy.
Is this the most recent combo video you put out? Or
no, it's this one? You know that Luna Melee guy who does like procedurally generated lists? Of combos and then curates them. Yeah.
The new Falco combo video with Mango though is very, very cool.
Nice. Do they have cool music?
I don't know. I don't really listen to the music. The one on Marth though. What's happening in this game so far though? Scraddles. Best of five the whole day? Okay.
Oh my god, it's gonna be a long one.
It is a very hyped tournament today, by the way, everyone. All the top players in SA are in attendance.
Is that true?
Nick. Yes, that is true. Nick, Muscat, McLeod, Ruben, Kai.
Florats.
Florats, Scraddles.
Yeah.
I think everyone's here. This is looking like a phantom top 16.
I'm very warm, I'm going to be honest. The mask and the room are doing it to me.
The fans are barely reaching us over here on the commentary couch.
And you know, that, the melee being such high octane is not helping things. I'll say that much. Yeah, look, somebody won that game. For sure.
Right.
So, absolutely. I think, I want to say the Scrad Daddy probably won it.
We'll see.
Let me just ask Muscat. Yeah, Brad won game one.
And Scrad Daddy did indeed win game one. And taking the lead in game two as well, Coffee Rex might not have the experience required to overcome this Fox. Goes for the cheese but misses it and gets edgeguarded in return. That is unfortunate.
I feel like Coffee should be good by now.
Coffee's very good.
He's big grinding. He should be good though, you know?
He's been banned from beginner beatdown. Entering a lot of... Yeah, Coffee's won like 3 times.
He's banned.
Banned, as in like graduated.
Okay.
You know, I think Coffee really is good. He just needs a lot of experience.
A lot of people graduated beginner beatdown. They had a purge, right?
I think so.
Yeah.
Who are the latest players to get purged from beginner beatdown?
I know Kismet's not allowed in there.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow, congratulations to Kismet.
Yeah.
I know Chibi is not allowed in there either.
But Chibi's high tier.
Oh, yeah, that's true. Wasn't RNG as well?
Graduated. I can believe it. Yeah, maybe Helium.
Maybe Helium. Maybe the big COD as well. A lot of people graduating from beginner beatdown. Coffee Rex definitely has the tech skill required to beat a lot of top players. Just needs the experience and the neutral game.
I feel like Coffee's option suite is somewhat limited. You know what I mean?
I think so too.
He likes to boil things down to the bare necessities.
Yep. Once he plays more and gets more mix-ups under his belt, then...
But I don't know if he's like trying... You know, like a lot of noobs have more mix-ups than Coffee Rex, you know? Seems like he wants to play in a game that he just does the right thing every time, you know?
And I get what you mean.
Yeah. That's not real, you know?
When a lot of noobs have a lot of different mix-ups, they might just be flailing around all of the time.
That's true. It's good to have a game plan.
It's
one thing you notice when you watch really good players is they... you can clearly tell what they're trying to do.
Game plans just make it a lot easier to analyze your sets as well.
Yeah.
You can clearly pinpoint where your game plan is falling apart. And most of the time, it's actually in punish.
Yeah. Pretty much all the time, to be honest.
Pretty much,
game plan is to do the biggest combo and then get a kill.
Puffy Rex takes the lead in this game, though. Currently being edge-guarded by Scraddles.
This would be a big win for Coffee Rex.
This would be huge. Goes out there, misses the edge-guard. You need to Armada Shine that, I think.
Yeah. He's probably choking. He probably knows it's make or break for his career. To beat Scraddles.
It's a very high-stakes tournament right now.
Oh, love the fade-in with the back air there.
And Coffee Rex takes game 2, 1-1. This would be an upset if Coffee Rex took the set, I would say.
I would be upset.
This would be upset.
Yeah, I'd be upset.
I'd be cheering. I love a good upset.
That's the difference between you and I.
There are many differences between you and I. Anyway, game 3, back to Battlefield. Wait, did they start game 1 in Battlefield? I can't remember.
I don't know. They might go to the stadium. Oh, wait, no, they went to Yoshi's.
They went to Yoshi's game 1, okay.
Yeah, you gotta pay attention.
Well, misses the punish again. I'll throw it up smash, but Puffy lands on the platform. Ooh. That's not gonna work.
That's a really slow nice side B off the ledge, and Puffy would, yeah.
Puffy clean enough to take that.
Puffy's been around netplay, he's seen side B off the ledge.
He's a master against all the cheese that netplay has to offer.
Yeah.
Oh, and shines the wrong way. That's unfortunate.
Oh my god. The
back to even stocks right now.
The Kami shine. That's what that one is, right?
Kami very well known for, a bit of Queensland lore for everybody. Kami is very well known for back throw shining foxes off stage.
Yeah.
That was what Queensland was known for a very long time.
No, they were known for having the swaggest players. Like Smoking Puppy, J-Dugs.
That is another thing Queensland's known for, but...
Psych.
At the time of Kami's prominence, I would say that Queensland was primarily known for cheesing people.
Really? Not my Queensland.
No, not your Queensland. How is Brad going to clean up the stock?
We've got a Hungry Jacks chant, by the way, happening in the crowd. Who do you think that's for?
Are gaming. And hungry.
I reckon it's probably for Scraddles. He's got the orange Hungry Jacks fox.
I would say so too. Scraddle has an opportunity to clean this up and does so.
The Coffee Rex is saying, I'm the Burger King of Melee. Remember that photo of
looking like a king right now. Oh, and Scraddle's cleaning it back up.
Wow.
Leading a revolt against the Burger King.
I know, that was crazy.
The Jax will rise up.
Yeah, that was a real hunger tamer.
Playing it a little bit slower now, just... Scraddle is very keen to get his dash dances, get his clean neutral opening, but... Coffee misses a punish and survives because of it.
Oh, you gotta hit those.
Yeah.
That could be Genesis. On another day, that's Genesis Grand Finals.
And Side B's back on the stage. Coffee not ready for that. Deathplay not preparing him just enough just yet.
Yeah. Maybe he's freaking out. You can't tell.
A lot of scraps right now.
Coffee has
gets a shield grab. Back air. Missed the edge guard. Misses the up smash. But...
Oh my god.
A lot of scuffles.
You know what I found out of that drill?
And Coffee takes this game in a nail biter game 3.
You know Fox Drill has a weak hit?
Really?
It's got the inner hitbox does 3% and the outer hitbox does 2%.
The inner hitbox does 3%?
Yeah.
So you want to hit people with the body hitbox?
Yeah.
Wow, I never knew
but
that.
But if you like just graze someone with drill, it does less knockback.
What?
Yeah, it does less percent.
Okay, so...
So it's like you get less hit lag, you know?
Do you know what the advantage on shield is for the weak hit then? Because usually it's like minus 6, 7, 8, right?
I feel like every time Dom B has done fade back drill on my shield, I've grabbed him 100% of the time.
Okay, that would make sense. One full percent difference.
Yeah.
Alright, we're back in this game. A lot of scuffles so far yet again. Both players have had their turn in punish. Both players have their turn in neutral again.
There's a couple of guys taking turns, playing melee. That's what it's all about, you know?
That is true. That is when melee
at the end of the bloody day. Oh. A lot of flailing. You know what I like about Coffee Rex? He's mysterious. Because his mask is comprehensive in its coverage of his face.
I feel like he's a real netplay character. We don't know him in real life a lot of the time.
You can't even see his face. You don't know what he's thinking. And that's dangerous.
What is he thinking right now? He's thinking about how to win this game.
Yeah.
How do I kill this Scraddles? And it's just an up smash like that. Next, how to win the next neutral interaction.
Yeah. You gotta wonder what other secrets he's keeping behind the mask, you know? He's probably got up smashes galore under there.
He got a bunch of whoppers under there because he is the Burger King.
Yeah.
Up tilt Scraddle's coming off the platform, but gets the trade really unfortunate.
Ooh,
there. Scraddle cleans up the edge guard because of it.
That was a bad angle from Coffee Rex. He input the wrong coordinates, it landed on stage.
I don't even know if the box has the right angle there.
Yeah. That's unlucky.
And Coffee Rex finding a lot of nairs. Scraddles can't get out of this situation right now. Ooh. Scraddles in the corner, rolls out, rolls back to the corner. Scraddles.
Oh, no down smash. He goes for a jab there, that's crazy.
Jab is very hard to hit on the side.
Ooh. And Brad hasn't hit any Armadas yet, but he's gone for a lot.
Well, maybe by game 5 they'll get it sorted out.
On the one hand, you got to admire his stick-tuitiveness. But on the other hand, you know, you gotta hit those.
You need a punish game plan, I think. Even if you're missing everything, you still gotta...
Yeah.
You know, you might hit it, and then you'll get the stock, and you'll be happy about it.
Yeah.
If you drop it... Eh.
And you'll say, that was worth the 7 times they died, you know?
Exactly. Oh, gets the back end.
Oh, he's gonna go ledge. He doesn't go ledge.
Goes
up.
No. Doesn't go...
Oh!
Ledge back... Ledge.
You see that?
I saw
that. He ledge dashed. He leg dashed.
Ledge dash up smashed.
Yeah.
Coffee finding the back air off ledge where Scraddle's caught him. He cleans up the stock.
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 Shout out to Jeff Fantastic.
You're gonna have to explain that one to me.
Don't worry about it, real ones now. you gotta stock of champions right now.
Stock of champions.
Yep.
This is not melee just yet, it's not game 5.
No, that'll be melee. Now it's just stock of champions and
back throw!
Goes for the coffee shine. Crazy side B.
Didn't even go out for the shine, just let him back on stage.
Scraddles could have just left the back air there and Coffee Rex would be dead, but you know, we don't live in that world.
Well, Coffee Rex could have gotten a grab there. Decides to waveland back.
Oh
finds
God.
The F smash.
They're kicking each other.
Back air, nice.
Pretty bad.
One more.
Not the best DI, I gotta say.
Doesn't need it, just rolls up. 2-2.
Wow.
This is a nail biter of a
Ladies
first
and gentlemen, this is melee.
This is melee.
This is melee. I just got word from the tournament organizers, and this is actually melee. right now.
Really?
Yep. Melee.
It's nice to have them confirm it.
Melee mode activated, exactly. Oh my god, he's drilling him!
Both players are moving a lot faster this game, I think.
Yeah.
A lot of moves being thrown out.
That's such an interesting option. The cross-up drill into another cross-up drill. Saying, I'm just going to spam moves. And
the other player might not be able to get out of it.
Exactly.
Not moving out of shield fast enough.
Oh,
charges the up smash, but it's a straight up DI. I think an up air would have just finished that, honestly.
Nah, I think you got to go for a pivot up smash there.
Or a pivot up smash as well. Even a back air as well, get the edge guard situation.
Hey, he got the clean up anyway, you know?
That's true. Up throw up smash. Good choice.
Oh, my coffee's crumbling. Oh, and he snaps to the ledge. By the skin of his, the hair of his chinny chin chin.
Skin of his teeth.
Oh my god.
Yeah, both players are nervous, Nick.
I think Coffee Rex might be the most nervous. Skrattles has been around the block.
Skrattles has never lost to Coffee, though. This could be weighing on him.
That's true. You gotta think about the psychological aspect. Oh my god.
He's brave enough to go for that one, though.
And he's dancing on him. You see that? He was dancing on
him. I saw that, yeah. Skrattles.
He was moving, and dare I say it, grooving.
He's moving this stock as well now. Oh, gets grabbed.
Oh,
never mind.
Yeah, the single hit.
The cowboy trick shot.
Yeah, you can't SDI that. It's a single hit.
Exactly. You know? You got to pull it down.
Don't even try. Don't even. Got no shot.
Oh,
he's out of there. You can't thunder combo me.
What's happening at the ledge here? Both players are getting hits in.
Yeah,
another
a lot
hit.
Of trading. And somehow Skrattles has only taken 15% out of that scramble.
Oh my god,
there it is!
There's
right,
the confidence!
Devin.
That's what he was going for all the time. You gotta stick to your punish game plan. God.
Coffee Rex is learning what it feels like to be swagged on in real life. You know, it's different.
He's gonna go on net play afterwards, hit up a couple of foxes, grind out the punish.
Exactly. Back to the lab again.
Oh, nice short in there by Skrattles, actually.
Oh my god, it's looking bad for Coffee Rex.
No, Coffee gets back on stage, he's alright.
Oh, it's still looking bad.
Finds the nair. Skrattles is in a corner, gets a grab.
Oh, you gotta
hit
those.
Follow up.
He probably went for an up smash. Oh, he's got
another up smash.
He wants it.
One more grab. Oh, no punish on either of these grabs, but finds the stray back air coming off the platform. And gets the edge guard. Alright, this is doable.
Yeah, Skrattles got two stocks of champions remaining. And Coffee Rex was only the one stock of champions.
But this is his stock of champions,
you know,
right now, though.
One stock in melee is not a lead, though. It's true. In fact,
oh no,
it's a disadvantage.
Makes it back.
Oh,
amazing drill there.
Yeah, great
amazing
drill
yet
he's
again.
Not, he's not getting follow-ups. I think he's trying to tech chase off the mistechs, which is actually optimal, but he's not getting it. You know,
very very difficult. Yep.
Oh, I thought he was gonna go for weak nair instead of the back air. He probably should have got a follow-up then. But
nothing. Was
up
that
nothing?
Bad drift on that. I wonder if that's a box thing, you know?
Probably.
You're trying to get the slight drift there.
He probably hit that 1.0 direction, you know, and
exactly.
He was out of there.
Oh, and this is it! Stock of champions! This is melee!
We got two stocks of champions right now. 109% stock of champions and 10% stock of champions.
Oh, what's happening? Coffee finds the drill!
Which stock
gets
of champions?
Gets a shine!
Will
tech chase! Up smash!
Oh my!
No!
Surely not. Yeah, okay.
Oh, and there we go. Skrattles cleans that up. Great set by the both of them.
Yeah, well played. That's melee, you know.
It's a nail biter of a first set.
There's winners and there's losers, but at the end of the day,
we're all friends here.
Well,
all of us, eh?
Some of us, yeah.
Most of us.
Yeah.
Can't speak
I
for
mean,
everyone, but
definitely some of us are friends.
Yes, yes. That is a true statement.
That's a true say.
And Skrattles will move on.
And I just want to know who we've got next, because I'm hungry for more.
I'm also just hungry in general.
Yeah.
But we will stick it out until the end of this tournament. And then
I gotta lean back. I gotta posture check.
My posture is ruined. Oh.
Yeah, I was yelling at the screen. I was this far away.
We were glued to the screen.
We
couldn't wait to see what happened next. Oh, next it looks like we have Ruben coming up. An Australian top 10 player, I wanna say.
Arguably, although based on his results at the summit,
the recent performance,
it's a little in doubt.
Yeah. Lost to McLeod, I believe, to place.
That's always been a bit of a demon for Ruben, the Peach matchup.
Yeah, that's also a really bad matchup for Samus.
Oh, and it's McLeod yet again.
Oh, this is a rematch of the summit set. And Ruben.
Yeah. I gotta go play Brad.
Okay, have fun.
Hey, wish Brad and me luck.
Good luck, Brad. Hello, Kaiser.
What's up, Davin?
Nothing much. So this is a rematch of the Summit set where McLeod knocked out Ruben.
This is huge, actually.
First round losers, exactly. I don't know who Ruben was playing last time, but it looks like he's going Falcon this time.
Cool, okay.
Might go better. Ruben, a top 10 player, and so is McLeod, I would say. They've both shown that they are very, very high school players in all of Australia.
That's sick, man. I love how SA has gotten so top heavy now.
Yeah, we have an extremely powerful state.
It's just because none of us stopped playing, you know? Yeah. Like, we all started playing, almost 6 years ago now, and then we're all just like, all right, well, we're not going to give up on this. We're all going to, grind till, we get to where we want to be. And now we have, some absolute killers.
We also run very consistent tournaments. EVAC is such a nice thing to have every week.
True that, actually.
Just attracts the right type of gamer.
Look, I'm just glad that I brought in my laptop that fateful day, and then we all just started talking shit on commentary.
And then what happened?
Yeah, that was just what happened, right? It was just a street gig didn't happen one time, and then Ali's like, "Hey, we run this video game club out of Adelaide Uni. You should come along." And then she's like, "Oh, we need commentators for Avcon," and I bought a $40 capture card and started practicing with everyone at EVAC.
Wow.
I'm like, that's how it all started, literally.
And now look at us.
Now look at us.
Having cheese leagues every month, weeklies every 2 weeks or so.
Shout out to McLeod as well for picking up the mantle on that.
Honestly, yeah, McLeod's been a great boon for the scene. He's also doing a lot of netplay tournaments as well. The McDongle Bongles. He's hosted four or five of them.
One day I will enter one of those. I'm always working on all of these netplay tournaments, which is really funny.
Yeah, the netplay tournaments are usually at strange times.
It's okay. We'll just deal with it. It's fine.
It's they're into the game now. Ruben with the combo gets McLeod in a... Oh. I get the reversal, though. Edge guard situation, and Falcon is dead there. Cannot come back. I think this matchup is slight Falcon favor, I would say. He has the speed to keep up with Peach in the combo game, as well as just maneuver around her. Peach, though, has a very strong combo game on Falcon.
Well, the biggest thing here is that Peach just gets to have all these kind of crazy reversals on straight hits that Falcon manages to pick up in neutral, where usually he can convert into something.
Oh, for sure. In close range as well, Peach's aerials a lot of the time can just outright beat Falcon's aerials, because Falcon's aerials are so slow or they have low priority. And that's what McLeod's really strong at, the close range fast aerials, because he subfloats them.
Oh yeah, he's sick, right?
Yeah.
I forget that he actually has that technology. Sometimes you just play him and then you hit him on the ground and it's just an instant reversal. I'm like, that's kind of bullshit.
He power shields, down smashes all of your approaches. It's like, what do I do?
It's kind of BS.
What am I meant to do? Exactly. And nice stock by Ruben there. Gets the edge guard. Pretty clean. McLeod's also been practicing ledge dashes with Peach, if you didn't know that. There's apparently some tech on the box where you can get 9 glint with Peach ledge dash.
What? Yeah. How does that even work?
I don't know, but McLeod's been practicing it, and I'm really curious to see if he's going to bring it out this set.
How does it... What?
I have no clue. Apparently, it requires 3 frame perfect inputs at once, or at a time.
All right. McLeod, something when you like watch that. This VOD, tell us how it works in the YouTube comments below.
Please do.
Nice. Should be a clean stock, but no, he flubs.
Back. Sneaks underneath.
You know, I don't know if it's just me, but I've just been noticing McLeod's a little less confident on edge guards since switching to box.
I would agree with you. I think a lot of players would say the same thing, how McLeod's a little bit slower, a little bit less confident in going for things on the box. But he's been practicing since Summit, and from what I can tell, he's gotten a lot better.
Wow.
Moving a lot more confident. Getting the edge guards he used to get.
Well, that's good.
Right now.
Because I always find, he messes up the drift on the down airs especially, and it's I don't know, it just doesn't seem to have that same level of like...
Drift control as a controller, yeah.
It just seems hard. You have to time things so like so close to each other and like get the drift timing really like correct.
Mm-hmm. I spoke with McLeod recently though, and I think he said that he feels as confident on the box as on the GameCube controller in certain matchups.
Yeah.
So we'll see about that.
Well, he's going 1-0 up, so it's not doing... He's actually doing something right.
He's doing very well. A close game for Ruben though. Ruben gets his pattern, but probably going Pokemon Stadium, if I had to guess. Yoshi's Story, okay. That's also, I would say, a surprising counterpick for Captain Falcon. Most Falcons don't like the stage in other matchups. Maybe in this matchup it's good.
Nah, big knees. Big knees
big
gonna
knees.
Come out. It Huge doesn't matter.
Knees. Gets the Pouchy down smash. That's the McLeod signature move.
Who was making the... It was Smoz, Sam from New Zealand, who was making like... it was like a TAS, like machine learning, like Peach bot, and it would just like power shield down smash your approaches, and it was just like everyone commented like, "Oh, it's working on AI Marta, right?" But really, what everyone saw in the video, they were just like, "It's McLeod. It's McLeod. Literally McLeod."
Probably the only Peach at a high level that does it consistently, I'd say. Definitely have not watched any Peach that does power shield down smashes to the same consistency. And
not in this country.
Definitely not in this country. Maybe not even in America.
Yeah, they usually go for other stuff, I feel. Mm-hmm. Like, they worked out CC down smash and ASDI down smash, and they're like, that's it,
we don't need anything else.
That's good enough for me.
Oh, that was such a nice float height to get the Nair into instant down smash there. Covers himself.
By the way, gang, let us know if the audio is alright. If I need to turn the game or the microphones up or down, please let me know and I'll do so.
Starting up the chain grab, gets the platform tech chase.
Oh, sick pressure.
Continues the pressure, yeah. Gets us into a full punish now. Ruben comes down with a stomp knee, and there it is. The Captain Falcon classic. The crowd goes wild.
Down air, forward air. So hype! Oh, I was expecting just to like have Ruben just do a raw knee there.
That would have been a very very brave maneuver to come off Randall with a knee. It probably would have worked as well.
Oh,
I wonder if Falcon gets a follow-up there. It didn't look like he could with that DI. But there must be something. Knee,
oh,
yep.
Very
and
nice.
And it's back to even straight away.
Very nice. I'm liking what I'm seeing from Ruben.
These sets today have been very close so far.
Oh, nice.
Ruben stuck on the platform. Comes down.
Wow, the sub float in air. Catching out Ruben from doing it down air. Ooh.
Oh, finds the gentleman
knee.
He's
dead. He's literally dead. Hold on.
1-1.
That was a big one, actually. For Ruben to actually convert those into knees, it's so important, and it's like, you don't want to be dropping those, I feel.
It's also a read as well, because McLeod did have the chance to tech, but you don't really expect to tech off of a gentleman most of the time. So it's good of Ruben to recognize that, go for the knee on the mistech. On just stomps in midair.
It doesn't even hit on the ground. It doesn't even hit. Maybe Ruben had some Samus muscle memory there and was like, this is it. This is how I hit him.
Just down smash, yep.
So Ruben far, he's just
playing
a lot
more on the platforms this game so far, I'd say. Now he's on the ground, but before, just stomping on a platform. Finds the Nair to knee. That's a good pickup.
I think he might want to be on the platforms on this stage, because if you let Peach to the platforms, it's kind of hard to, like,
hit her. Look how he's playing right now. He's just playing safe on top platform, and he's back there again.
Yes,
this
gameplay.
Really smart. I'm really liking this gameplay from Ruben.
Nice.
Oh,
I can't believe
corner.
That.
Oh, wow.
I yeah. can't believe that hit.
It hits people way more often than it should, I feel. They're just praying to God that the Raptor Boost hits. And it often
Ooh.
Does.
Unfortunate
back
there.
Back to a platform. Just falling down with platforms with arrows off of them. I want to know how McLeod is going to start dealing with
oh
this.
Oh my God.
Right now, whatever he's doing is not working.
That knee was nuts.
That knee was insane.
Oh, beam sword though. Oh, pressure.
Right. Rolls out of it. Back to a platform. Maybe
oh,
this is not
damn.
A great counterpick.
I think this is still the pick. It's just that Ruben was, like, prepared. He understood, like, this is what I have to do. J-Nuts with the raid of 10. Thanks for stopping by, everyone. Welcome to South Australia.
Hello, J-Nuts, 24.
Thanks for supporting some local melee.
And Ruben kind of running away with this game, honestly. Macau can't really seem to get in and just goes for the raw knee. That is confidence.
Oh, no! I'd be pretty... I'm not going to be say, like, McLeod's tilted at the moment, but he's definitely like, ah, crud.
I think he's really thinking about what to do, honestly.
Yeah,
he's... How do I get in on this Falcon?
You can see the cogs turning.
Exactly. Okay, cleans that stock up. Ruben has three more to work with. Gets another stomp. Oh, stomps have been the name of this
Just
game.
Do it again.
Wow.
Nipple, come on. Oh, he fucked up the double jump. If he timed it a little bit better, it would have worked. Finish it with a nipple, please. Oh. Nah, it doesn't hit.
And just a simple down throw up air. All right, Ruben with a clean game, too.
That was nice.
The game plan, and he really stuck to it.
That was so nice. That was so, so nice.
It's really... It's enjoyable to watch close games, but it's also enjoyable to watch games with a clear game... with a clear game plan work out like that.
And well, for me...
going to FD doesn't want to deal with the platforms and gets the chain grab on this stage.
Yeah, for me, it's like... when I see players like acting that way when it's tournament sent, it feels a bit more like what I expect like people to play like in tournament. Because sometimes you get people who are just only interested in running at the other person, and it's like, you know, it's tournament and there's 8 minutes on the clock and like,
yeah,
there's like stakes on the line and stuff. So it's like, don't be afraid to use all like the options that the game gives you instead of just being like, no, I want to like play the most amount of melee in the shortest time possible.
Especially if the option is working, like,
yeah,
some
yeah.
kind of platform. If it works, then just keep doing it.
Careful. McLeod already looking a bit more in control of this game.
Let's see if he can finish this edge guard. Goes lower,
wow.
And Ruben actually makes it back.
Yeah, that nair not reaching low enough to hit Falcon on recovery.
McLeod shaking his head a little bit there. I wonder what he's thinking.
I mean, McLeod's also, like,
dropping that.
At least not dying immediately. Because, like, a stray hit here from Ruben, like a nair, could just lead into a combo off stage and then that's
oh,
it.
For sure, yeah. Any back air, gentleman, nair, anything.
Who's your boy in this game, actually?
I'm going for Ruben in this game.
Oh, okay.
But I cheer for both players. They're
right,
both
SA. Who's your boy this tournament?
This tournament?
Hmm.
I'd say myself.
Oh, I like that.
I'm not going to cheer for someone else.
Yeah, good. That's good. That's good. I needed to know.
But close second, probably Muscat. I'm a huge Muscat fan. And
Muscat
well.
For second.
Muscat
Ooh.
Is a very strong player. I want people to know
oh,
how strong
sick.
Muscat is.
He's really good at the game.
Exactly. He didn't make it to the latest summit, but he's probably also top 10 in Australia, I would say. We have a lot of them. Top 10s.
Top 10 is filled with 7 SA players.
Right.
That's a bit of a stretch, but you
it's
feel
not
me.
Too far of a stretch.
It's not too far off.
Right, McLeod looking in control in this game so far. Ruben can't finish the stock off. He needs to find some sort of... Oh, there
nice.
We go.
Oh, what's up, Sam? Good to see you in chat, man.
It's a grab. Ooh, oh, for the re-need there.
Oh, he's dead. Oh, no, he knew.
What?
He actually knew, but also, like, Ruben could have just, like, up-eared. Not too much. We were just commenting on how back in the day you were working on AI Marta, and then everyone who watched the video of it, like, Power Shield down smashing, was just like, ah, oh, that's just McLeod, actually. You're making a McLeod bot.
I wonder what the Falcon follow-up off the down throw there is. Ruben went for a knee there and got nared in the face for it off of the down throw, so I wonder if there's something.
Ooh, nice!
Nice!
We got a match though.
Yes. This is a Stock of Champions happening right now.
This is literally Stock of Champions! So, McLeod is actually finding his way, like, barely out of these combos that seem
oh,
really good.
Oh, nice! That is clean.
Damn, that was a combo! Let's and fucking go!
Finishes that game off 2-2, alright.
Yes!
But I really want to see Ruben stick to his game plan from FOD and how McLeod's going to deal with it. But he picks Pokemon Stadium, actually.
Oh.
This is probably the standard counter pick. But when you have a game plan that's working, yeah.
Yeah.
When you have a game plan that worked as much as it did on FOD, then it's kind of interesting to pick the stage.
Oh my god.
Oh, wow.
Huge damage. I like the turn up there, but Ruben's really smart. Didn't get hit.
Gets a nice fastball to ledge as well, stopping McLeod from getting there.
I agree with what Skip said in chat, that top 10 in Oz is actually 20 people. Because they're all just from different regions, and it's so hard to judge like who actually fits the bill.
A lot of players can beat a lot of other players. It's very,
yeah.
The Australian, like, high to mid level is very fluid, I would say.
Yeah, because at the moment it's like... It's just one of those things, and I think it's just because, like, SA has quite a lot of them as well. Like, we can all kind of beat each other on any given day, right? Like, it's one of those, like, variable skill...
And McLeod like, just not recovering there.
Box and whisker graphs or whatever.
Oh, for sure.
So it's like, everyone can kind of beat everyone, but we haven't really seen who's, like, got the medal to be, like, the most consistent at the top of the food chain of that.
Yeah.
And, I mean, Nick is probably the obvious pick, though. And he's probably like the most consistent.
I would put Nick at a tier above all those high to mid tier players. It's like Nick, Sock. Nick and Sock, I guess.
Yeah, so it's Josh, Nick, Sock, like without question, right? And Sock and Nick are like arguably equal in skill.
And then after that, everyone else is. They could all beat each other.
I mean, I think there's people who actually don't fit in top 10 as well, though. Like.
Yeah.
I'm not like firing shots or anything here, but like. Goody and Mello just aren't of the top 10 caliber just yet.
No, but they are getting there, though.
They are quite good. Huey's quite good as well. I think Huey's definitely top 20 at this point.
Huey had a very nice run at Summit last weekend, or a couple weekends ago.
I was watching Huey all day. I'm like, he's kind of on fire at the moment.
His Moth matchup, which is so surprising.
Yeah, yeah.
Foxes struggle at that matchup a lot of the time. Going game 5 against Melodic. Beating Dekar is no joke.
Yeah, exactly. He had a good run. Very good run. And I'm also glad that Dekar got to play after losing to me on phone internet at the
Hyrie
at
would
the
watch
last chance.
Yeah, Hyrie would be also in that Nick soft tier as well.
You guys talk all this shit about Hyrie. I bet you wouldn't even say that to him in real life.
I definitely would not. He's jacked.
He's jacked. He goes to all the hottest places, has all the hottest guys around him.
Sees all the hottest K-pop concerts around.
True.
All there.
This is kind of looking rough for McLeod now, though. All because Ruben actually got to have a counterpick in game 5 after like turning the tide in FOD. Just looking so hard.
Seems to be the deal breaker in the set.
Nice.
Ruben also playing. Oh, a lot of those spot dodges there. I think were attempted passes, down smashes. Not too sure what else they could have been.
McLeod's defense has actually picked up like a notch in this last stock, though. He understands that it actually is not beneficial for him to take any extra damage that he doesn't need to.
Oh. Okay.
Oh my god. No
he
tech.
He has a chance to equalize this game, actually.
Careful. So some small trades here and there for McLeod, but it's actually working for him very well.
Gets off the ledge.
Oh, nice.
But gets an accidental roll in, and McLeod cleans it up. This is very, very even. Falcon can get comboed quite easily.
All right, Ruben has to not get too greedy here and try and cash out, like, I don't know, on something that isn't true.
You can just find some stray nair or gentle.
Oh my god, that's it.
Five to stop knee,
that is it.
That is the game.
Oh my god, that was sick.
And Ruben with the win over McLeod.
That was a good way to end it too, because I thought McLeod was going to bring it back.
That was...
huge. Good job.
That's gigantic. Congratulations to Ruben.
Good shit, Ruben. All right. It's us now. We're up next, buddy.
We are?
Yeah. Oh, it's us two.
Okay, sick.
All right. So we got me and Davox on stream next, y'all. Thanks for having us on. We'll see you later. We'll see you on the other side.
Peace.
Hello. Let's see. Everything's already filled in. That's pretty good. Yeah, sure. Joining me on commentary is Jeff. J. Jeff. Is the first J? Is the first J silent? Yeah. Pretty much, yeah. I haven't actually seen this set in quite a long time, to be honest. There used to be a period where it was myself, Davin, Kai, and like top three back in around, like, because Nick wasn't showing up to stuff back in early 2019 or whatever. They see a set a bunch, but nowadays it's just it is. Yeah.
When did McLeod become a box enjoyer with the hitbox?
Oh god, like maybe a month and a half, 2 months ago.
Really?
He's
acclimating pretty well.
No, he really is. Yeah, he's been grinding it.
Yeah,
spending a lot of time.
I'd say Peach is probably one of the maybe easier characters to change to box with.
Maybe. I have no idea, to be honest. I can't. But you just think, because like...
Fucking turnips.
Huh?
It'd be good for throwing turnips. You get really consistent angles like, constantly.
You think?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay. But I don't think the control stick really matters with turnips though, right?
You think?
No, I'm pretty sure she can only throw them in...
Just horizontal
like,
and
like, yeah, in like four directions. Yeah, right. I don't think it actually matters what... Oh, do you imagine though, if you could like pinpoint aim turnips, that would actually be sick.
45 degree turnip.
Exactly, like throw a turnip off stage like a Sheik needle.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
Oh, this looks fun. I haven't seen Sheik in so long.
I always really enjoy watching Davin Sheik.
I just enjoy watching Sheik.
Yeah, like a fast Sheik that actually has decent movement is just, and like decent follow-ups off the... It's really enjoyable to see.
Yeah. I feel like the character is just so horrible to play against, but when other people are playing against, you're like, ah.
I can finally enjoy
it. Yeah, like half of the stress of watching it is gone.
Sure. And Davin, one of the rare Sheiks that actually can tech chase decently well. I wouldn't say he's 100% consistent, you know, touch of death off a grab, but... He definitely gets more for grab than most Sheiks in Oz.
Who do you think is going to take it?
I think Davin's is the favorite.
You reckon?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think Davin's the favorite.
Has he been grinding?
I don't think so. I'm not sure. I think he's just like a bit better than Kai at the moment, but like not by much. I think Kai can definitely take it, but I would say the odds would be, you know, Davin favored.
We'll see.
Oh, going in. Let's.
Yeah.
Hell yeah. Oh, we're on the mirror.
There we are.
Nice. Oh, no, wait. No. They put in the names in the... Never mind, we can swap it through this way.
There we are.
Hell yeah. All right, cool.
So we're seeing Davin just getting dead kinda into the crust of the
just
earth.
Just kind of getting Goomba stomped at the moment. Yeah. He's
How do you feel like this... I feel it's probably better for... Probably Sheik to play this map because, I mean, Kako gets less vertically or horizontally. He still gets the same amount vertically no matter what.
True.
If by there is going to kill you.
It's one of those things where, like, she can definitely, even at high percent, she can DIA up and, like, come back from a decent... But she still has to play a landing mix-up, right? Because, like, she can't comfortably go to ledge. She can comfortably go to ledge if it's given up to, but, like, if Falco grabs ledge, then she still has to play a mix-up. There's no, like... Yeah. And it's very easy once Sheik's not a decent far way to like just grab ledge, do standard get up, knock her back off stage, rinse, repeat.
Yeah.
Plus the triplat sort of. I mean, Sheik just really likes having side plats, right? It's like having some way to mix up movement that's not just like ground based.
Or just legging it towards you and hoping. And Falco's good at people just beelining it towards him.
Because you have to do. It's so hard as Sheik to get that first 20-30% unless they give it to you for free. So it's like you have to find some way to like nickel and dime Falco until you're like.
You get like 10% and then won't be able to finish it off because your hits are going nowhere. Or
like you can see here, like every single hit so far has just been Sheik like doing a fadeaway aerial.
Yeah.
Because like if the grabs aren't. Being given up, it's just like, well, I'll get my 8 or 9 here, and then now we're at a percent where Sheik can start
killing, doing something.
Where, like, fair, stuff like fair and back air is going to actually knock down.
Yeah.
So now the Falco is a bit more scared of aerials, and Falco starts shielding a bit more, and then once they start shielding more, grab starts becoming more of an option. Like, because you can't just, like, you can't just rely at low percent on just as Sheik just by shield grabbing or just running up raw grab. like, it's not going to work at a certain, like, level of play.
Yeah, it's just not going to work against Falco as well.
It's, yeah.
He's just going to get pinged and pinged and tinged.
Oh, he wanted that great. He got a little greedy. Yeah. He's
waiting for the... He keeps getting in on him with, like, water cancel nairs. Sheets.
Grab sledge, can we see? Ah, goes for shine. Interesting. I'm not sure if that... It's hard.
Yeah.
Oh,
the gimp. He's in that tiny little box near the ledge where Sheik has all of her options available. Mm. You just have to eat something. You all go right below and you get hit by a needle, or she runs off stage and bears you, and you have to try and tech off.
Yeah, yeah. It's hard. It's, yeah, it's, yeah, that's right. It's, yeah.
I feel like learning to tech back onto the stage, like, or tech on stage when you've been hit, like, you know, off stage, it's so. It can create, like, such incredibly clutch moments.
Ooh, so much, this is so... Oh, oh wait, oh. Nope. Managed to get back to ledge off a double jump.
And stage control is gone.
Oh, ooh, really nice shine out. But this is so scary for Falco. Nice, nice tech, though. But he just holds shield and he gets grabbed.
Oh,
oh, this needle. He has to hit it. He has to... Yeah. I was about to say, like, if he got, if he didn't get shield off, he has to go for the arms tech. Oh, he misses the...
Ah, stage.
Ah, unfortunate. Oops. That is... I'd imagine we're going FD or Stadium, to be honest. Mm. Yeah.
FD?
Yeah. Mm. Good thing? I think.
You think? Yeah,
I think.
Yeah, I think too, actually. Yeah.
Yeah, I think if you're a Spacey, you're like two big counter picks in this matchup. FD and Stadium.
True.
I think Davin is definitely one of the better streaks in Oz on Stadium. He's just quite good at playing that, like, grounded game, but it's still, it definitely still nerfs the character.
Yeah, you have to be a masochist to play Pokemon Stadium anyway, so.
Hell no, there's no transformations now, so it's really just the, like, janky edges.
Yeah. Slippy's totally just been like, oh yeah, sorry guys, we didn't know how to code it, so just gonna have to deal with it.
And, what?
You know, a year later. Well, that was the original reason we didn't have transformations, because it was to do with the neck.
Yeah, code,
which
true.
I do not believe. I think it's all a ploy.
It's just all a ploy to get, look.
To get rid of those fucking transformations. Nice.
I don't think, I feel like they were going to be phased out regardless, though.
Yeah, they're incredibly competitively unviable. It's just not fun.
It's just not, yeah. Even as a Fox, let me tell you, there's definitely been a set in the past against Davin where last game, I just get like an infinite drill or whatever on like a Stadium transformation. It's just, it's just janky and
the
BS.
The antithesis of good melee is Pokemon Stadium. That was pretty...
Ooh, the nice power shield.
That is so good. Whenever he blocks a shine on shield or a laser on shield, he always just...
He's very quick out of it. Yeah. And that was just that little movement, just a sneak past Falcon Legend, just put himself in a really strong position. He went from having... went from recovering to having all the stage control, and now he's just on... Ooh. Gets the DAO to shield, but doesn't... Well, doesn't get a clean hit. Trades. And... Okay. Nice. But how much can he... How long can he hold onto the stock, though? Ah, the up tilt trades.
Any percent he gets here is huge.
It's so tempting when you're in the corner just to double or just to full hop out. Just to jump in general. Kai jumping before and just realizing better that, like, oh, this isn't going to work out well for me and just fading back. Gets.
Wow. He got so much off of that invincibility. He literally just ran into him and sucked him.
How much is this going to be, though? This.
Wow.
Does the...
Sad. Do you reckon the second jab screwed that, or?
Well, no. I think the idea of the second jab is to mix up like the SDI.
Yeah.
Because like the Falco will miss tech, the Sheik will jab, and then the Falco will SDI, and then the Sheik will jab again to try and mix up the. But then the Falco keeps SDIing.
Yeah.
Oh, that code there was a little bit sketch, but still gets so much, and this is. This feels really scary as the Falco. I mean, I'm sure it's scary as the. Sheik, but it's the Falco, just like, there's so many things that are just going to lead into a fair and just... He calls out the shine stall.
Yeah, the patience would have paid off really big, but...
Just waits it out, puts himself in a position where there's nothing the Falco can do. Alright, we're gonna how are we closing out the stock?
Let's Tech Chase for 3 years. Nice.
Ooh.
And he's guess wrong.
There's like okay.
Nice. That's a good way to end that.
Still Falcons at 44. That's a decent way into the Sheik just being able to throw out aerials and them not get CC'd.
It is mind-numbingly tilting, taking percent when you're like down a stock. And you, like even 15% is just the
worst. Really good ledge dash up tilt, especially in the close last stock situation. You still need to go for it. It's, you can't be doing double lasers and hoping that they are bad.
See the SDI on the laser?
Mm.
Chucked him off the ledge.
Oh, this is scary because it's gonna be just fair, and then just.
Oh no!
He gets Falco. He gets Falco. Jeez. Oh, that's happened to everyone. I think you've been playing melee for this long. You've lost a game. You've definitely lost a game in a like somewhat important set. Yeah, I mean it's a local, but you still want to win this. Like you've lost a tournament. Well, a tournament game. Yeah. To Falco side B.
Oh, that's so sad.
Yeah.
Straight back into it.
Straight back, yeah. You just have to. Yeah, absolutely. You just have to be like, well.
Yep. It happened. Don't do it again.
Because like, that's not the reason why you lost the set. Like, it's one of the reasons, but like, it was that close and that had to begin with because of many other factors.
It was a really quick first stock by the Sheik.
It was.
Loving slide plats.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, sad.
Ah, it's unfortunate. We're back on Battlefield. Yeah. We have, Sheik gets to do her little movement mix-ups, positioning mix-ups on the platforms.
Nice. Crouch cancel by Sheik. Why not the Sheik by Falco? We just couldn't get anything off of it.
Yeah. Ah, that's a... I really don't like that smash. I'm not sure if that was intentional. Because sometimes, I know myself, I'll try and buff a roll and then accidentally get F smash.
Yeah. Oh, it's so scary. Look at the size of that shield.
Yeah.
It's shield. You have to angle it up not to get smashed by fair.
Oh, no.
Unfortunate. You know why that happened, though, right? He was on 69%.
Oh, he might be back. Forget that. He's already. Oh, this has been a.
That's a nightmare situation.
When you play Sheik and they can actually get like more than 20 off her grab, you're like, what? No.
Yeah. It's not meant to be this.
This
way.
It's not meant to be this way.
unfortunate.
Not the cleanest set.
Yeah.
No, not at all. But it's okay. There's still time to pick up.
Yeah, I mean, every game of Melee is
he can just grab ledge here.
Yeah.
And just Davin's slightly glasses. Shaking his head a little bit. I would be like, get all the sleep. It's hard. It's hard to, like, not be in that mentality.
Yeah.
Ooh, but he's...
Man.
I also thought up tilt was the right choice.
Yeah,
but
just not low enough. Barely not low enough.
Oh, this should be it. That's, once you get the out. Very. Like, even though it's like, Devin's on the edge out of, how many times, just.
That was a really quick needle as well.
Yeah, and just to immediately wave dash. It's the execution. Even, like, it's relatively simple stuff, but it's like, in that last stock situation.
Yeah, last stock situation, in a tournament, winner's quarters. You just got Falco'd last
You just
game.
Got, yeah. It's very easy just to kind of be risk averse and stay on that ledge.
Yeah. But paid off.
It did,
Now we're on FOD. Lovely stage.
Lovely stage?
Yeah. If you're not playing Puff, it's great.
Yeah.
I think it's still pretty good for Puff. Man, so pillar.
I know one of the reasons why Kai likes this stage as well is when he's doing his like pillars and he finishes it with like a dare onto like one of the side plats. It's really easy for him to get like a tech chase afterwards.
Yeah,
because like the actual side plats and top plat I guess are like so like thin, not thin, like short like that like stuff like a Falco down smash pretty much covers everything.
Yeah, exactly. As long as it's not on one of the extremes.
Yeah.
you know, guess super wrong, you're probably going to get something, or you're just not going to get punished for the option that you choose.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, unfortunate.
Ooh, oh, he gets SDI, yeah. Really good SDI, but then Sheik doing the counterplay to that afterwards, yeah. The up tilt.
Same thing, wave dash off stage. Bear. Eat the foot.
Mm-hmm.
Ooh. Oh, nice spot dodge. Holy moly.
He's just... He's up airing like he's a fox.
He twisted him, bro.
Uh-oh, he's getting...
Nice. Dude, the platform went down at the perfect moment.
Yeah.
If that was like a combo 1 second earlier, it would have gone completely different. He probably could have still gotten something off the platform, but it's kind of hard to see. Nice. How's he going to get in from the needles? And he's just...
He goes down for... It's a weird bear. I guess he was hoping Sheik would recover sooner.
Yeah, oh, that's it. All right, now it's up to how much percent she can get here. I'm getting rocked. It's going to really, really help. Even if it's 15%, as you said earlier, the first 30% is just miserable.
It is. Nice. This has to be it if you're... I guess, yeah, just got sent too high from the shine.
Yeah, at this point, lasers matter just to, you know, stop I mean, attacks.
Yeah, lasers...
The percent is negligible.
Okay.
44%.
44. That's
an enormous amount of damage.
Mm.
That just like puts him.
Oh, Falcon in the corners is very scary. That was actually a really nice fadeaway now.
Yeah.
Just like very low committal.
And the follow up is.
Oh, that's.
No! Oh!
This has
no.
been.
2-2.
This is.
This is fun.
A lot of unfortunate situations, but yeah. It's also. They're both messing up equally, so it's a very, well, somewhat equally. So
makes for a good game.
It makes for at the very least, you're not going to know who's going to win.
Yeah, all bets are off.
Go straight back, yeah.
Fan of dreams, I'll just say it.
Makes sense, right? It's either this or Yoshi's.
Yeah. And Yoshi's is like such a momentum heavy map. I feel like Davin's been carrying so much momentum. As soon as he wins neutral, it's just shit like this. It's just rocking.
Ooh, the up. Ah, wait. It's interesting. I guess, yeah. It's hard. It's hard to like react to the DI off the up tilt. Because I'm pretty sure that DI, he could have just F-tilted.
Yeah. Wow. Very clean first stop.
I mean, sorry, not the up tilt, the up throw. Ooh, sneaks under with the
Yeah, such a gutsy needle.
Oh, this
is scary.
Oh no! The right option, then just... I guess he was trying to, like... He was pressing L anyway in case he teched, and he just pressed L too late.
Yeah. Just that buffer win. You reckon it was buff? Probably buffer.
Yeah. I don't think it was buff. I think he just pressed it a bit too late. No, it could have been buffered.
Who knows? Can it happen?
It's gonna
dude. I love that bit of tech. The runoff stage up B, like the double
pick. Yeah, no, oh, it's always so sick to see.
It looks so nice. I remember hating Sheik for the longest time, and then I watched this clip of MTK on Twitch just doing that tech like 15 times in a row, and I was like, you know, this character's kind of sick.
This character's kind of sick.
Can kind of do some stuff.
Ah, this is... Oh! Nope.
Nah, not gonna... Oh, unfortunate. If one of the platforms was up, that probably would have been death, but...
Look, the Falco definitely has a mount in the head, but...
Yeah. It's climbable. Oh, nice tech.
That okay, yeah. Oh, nice. Nah, a little bit too slow off the initial...
Oh! That recovery.
The people coming, myself, Musket,
right.
And
we can
Jess.
This in.
Oh, yeah, it's true.
Muscat winners. Alright, that's it.
Up next, I believe. Actually, no, we are. What would we would have Nick and Ruben.
Nick and Ruben. Alright.
No, yeah.
You can sort this shit out.
Yep.
Yeah, really fun set to watch.
Mmm.
a few blunders in there. A
few blunders, but...
makes for a great game. You said that the four by accident.
What's that?
Yeah, it's a four.
Oh, what the hell? I thought I hit...
first to ten.
Yeah, first, yeah, yeah. we'll swap player info.
Cool. Oh, man, I'm really looking forward to this.
Mm.
I love seeing Marth get kneed.
Get kneed, yeah?
Oh, dude. I hate...
you might also see be seeing Falcon get down to it, so...
yeah, I'm probably going to be seeing more of that. I think if we go...
hmm? Oh, they swapped. Oh,
yeah.
Okay, yeah.
Just ports.
Ah, yeah.
All right, Battlefield.
It's going in or they hand one?
I think a hand one.
Yeah.
Yeah. No fist bump equals no... yeah, down tilt's horrible, dude. Monster move.
Monster, the mega move.
I regret... I played with this Marth player for a while. Mm-hmm. And he was just like, dude, I just can't get in. Getting like constantly screwed, and I was like, just down tilt me instead of doing anything else, and you'll catch me every time I short hop there or short hop there or short hop there. You just catch me so much.
Who are you playing?
Puff.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm a degenerate man.
Huh.
What's up with Puff?
Yeah.
It's so good at dealing with Puff. It's just such a versatile move. It comes out so quick. It's really low committal.
Interesting. Down tilt. I actually didn't think of that as a
It's the Puff killer.
The Puff killer. All right. Well, you heard it here first.
All right, game on. Love seeing Ruben on the Falcon.
The Falcon, yeah.
I think Samus is so much cooler, but his Falcon it just translates.
Just translate.
The sickness, the swag.
Look, no comment. I'm actually not. I'm not a I'm not a big Falcon fan.
Oh, I hate Falcon.
I might actually be...
I like Ruben. I like Ruben more than I hate Falcon.
I think all of Ruben's characters are actually really solid.
Yeah.
Like, really. It's always really enjoyable seeing Ruben play. Seeing Falcon, on the other hand, yeah. Like I said before, not one of the biggest Falcon fans. Might be one of the biggest Falcon haters.
It's probably because you've, played against so much Falcon.
I'm not going to get into... not going to get into why I hate Falcon. But it's definitely not one specific player. It's Falcon as a concept.
Yeah, Falcon is a concept.
Falcon is a concept.
Falcon is a spectrum.
But what's it, you know, I feel like public perception is shifting a little bit towards the more Falcon is, you know, not quite as hype as he used to be. But
he's just not cool, man. He does the same shit a million times. It's cool until you get kneed.
I will not stand for this hate speech. Look, Caleb wishes every day that he lived in Vic and he could get all the love the Falcon gets there, but...
does Falcon get love in Victoria?
Yeah? Anyway, we've had enough of... yeah, look, enough of this hate speech, but yeah. We've got to focus on what we've got in front of us here, and what we have in front of us here is not just a Falcon, we also have a Marth.
Yeah, exactly. And Nick, which we haven't... I haven't seen him. Quite a while. I saw his match against Brad earlier. That was a lot of fun to watch.
Ah, yeah, yeah.
It's it's like a like Deckard with a brain. You know?
Deckard with a brain?
It's fun to watch. Deckard
look,
with like
Compton Marth. Compton Marth.
Compton Marth.
No, for both. Like watching Deckard play, like he
it
made
blows my mind.
No, he like even like he does some actually like. Generally smart stuff.
Yeah, of course. His fundamentals are so insanely rock solid. But he's definitely a better player than Nick.
It's definitely a different style than Nick. What I meant was like watching two like watching just Compton Marth in general, be it like Deckard style, Nick style. It's always enjoyable. Not as much when you're playing it, but you know. Not as much when you're playing it.
Dinosaur.
Oh no. Alright, well.
We're kinda just shit talked over that entire game.
What? It's a free stock.
Yeah.
I'm sure Marth swung. Probably not that much actually. Nick's not really a. Well, I was about to say Nick's not a swinging Marth. Then he just like
down tilts.
Nick's
nothing.
A calculated swinging Marth. Mm. Like, Nick's very good at dashing back, and then you think, oh, this Marth's dashing back, I'm going to dash forward. Then he, like, goes forward to...
Yeah. Just Marth, when Marth knows how to cover space, it's yeah, so exactly. hard to do anything against him.
When Marth's good at, like, actually using empty movement to take space, and, oh...
Man, what?
Oh, that's...
The Marth killer.
And, like,
the
dealing
Falcon
with...
The killer.
It's like, it's... When Marth's actually able to, like, deal with your attempts to take space against him, that's when it gets really scary.
Yeah.
You're like, I'm moving forward, but I'm getting hit or grabbed out of it. I expect, yeah. This is,
Man. Do you reckon Dreamland is to blame here, or...?
No, I don't... I don't think, I think there's... Stage is definitely not the reason why he's getting kind of owned right now.
Yeah.
Look, it's happening. It's happening.
Oh, yeah.
If he, he looks back at the set, he'll be like, yeah, I got owned. Sometimes you get owned. And it'll happen to you.
Man. Yeah, oh, dude, it's happened to me a million times. I get my shit pushed in by Marth. Reverse 4-0. Hooked up to a lethal dose of hopium, right?
Hopium? Look, he just needs four grabs. He's gotten one. Can he get the stock from this? He see?
Yeah.
Okay, three more grabs.
Man, that he was hogging the ledge for a while. He did have over 100%.
It's great. Yeah, when like ledge get up and like get up attack, ledge get up attack and ledge roll above 100. It's crazy how long it actually covers ledge for. Can someone get someone to open the door for me on the
gym side of the
side?
Just
oh,
out
yeah.
there.
Yeah.
All right. Cool. Well, let's go. We'll be back shortly. It's game two. Where are they going? Dreamland again. Yeah, fair enough. Oh, it's the same shit that's happening. That start is so rough. It's just mentally exhausting getting smacked around by Marth. I can take it from Fox.
So I'm going to assume in my absence he did not take free stocks from free grabs.
Oh,
but
it's actually game four. I forgot to put it in.
He's looking a lot better this game, though.
Yeah, way better. The start had me a little worried because he just got, you know, same shit happened.
And
it run in, and then he takes all of the stage presence and gets him on the top platform. He was able to recover pretty well. But this is, like, much better look right now.
Ah, unfortunate. Ooh, just get sliced. Just yeah.
Do you think if Melee HD was made, they'd make the gentleman not so impossible to do?
I feel like Melee HD would just follow power, right?
Yeah.
Which means that'd be another hit might not actually get played. So it's explosive.
I think power melee is really fun.
But it's not as explosive, Jeff.
Yeah. Well,
when Fox up smash kills at 80,
yeah.
It's explosive. You play Puff. Of course you prefer Pal.
Yeah.
Filthy degenerate.
Just not getting destroyed as hard by Fox smash. But Marth is, like, I think more
Oh, what happened? I'm not gonna lie. I was...
Yeah, he got... just can't comboed into death.
Yeah.
He's getting... Just cannot get back. He's lost in at sea in Dreamland.
Oh, Lord. Wispy's looking. Wispy's like, you got this, bud. Oh, sending positive vibes your way.
With his...
Oh, okay. This should be it. No, never mind. He has to play a mix-up.
No, it'll be fine.
Yeah, I mean. Yeah. Hey, wow. Okay, well, he played the mix-up and he got back. Look, this isn't anywhere near as bad as last game. He can... Especially if you can get a...
This is
money right now. Oh, that down air may not have been money. Oh, this is going to be...
This is... All right, gets back. That was really, really scary.
That was really scary.
Nice tech. Missing the tech there sucks so bad. It's like being a little bit slow and then just getting chased. Damn! All right.
Well, I believe it's myself and Devin up now.
All right. Let's go, Nick. Yeah. That was really good. I think that third game there was way closer. Put Nick, put him back on the screen. Should he just sit in the back? I can. Hang on. For the next one. That's it. Now. Alright. Yeah, no. In a moment, we'll get Bailey and Ruben on to do some comms. This will be a fun game to watch. This is winner semis, right? What? No, you're fine. This is winner semis, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, cool. Alright.
Hello.
I'm off and off.
God. Give me more length. So lean back.
We're getting straight into it, aren't we?
Straight in? Yes. I hope so.
I love hearing you in my ear like this. It's so nice.
It is quite
How
good.
Much do we want Davin to win?
I don't know. It's kind of funny having Musket just like...
A Musket being like, Davin is a really good scenario. Well, but I just love Davin too much.
I just think it's funny, like, Musket owning the locals and just doing fuck all when it comes to majors. I like that narrative.
I want to see him do well in majors, though.
I just want him to do well in locals.
Prey on Musket's downfall. Yeah.
Which it should be the other way around, right? Because you want to beat Musket.
I want Davin to win still.
Okay. Well,
he's so slick with it.
He must have given you quite a tasty Luxor at Danny Tai's business.
It wasn't a Luxor, okay. It was some lamb. I think lamb something.
Lamb
it was delicious.
Something.
Absolutely dead set delicious.
Dead set.
She's got such long limbs, eh? How tall do you reckon Sheik is? No canon. Like, I don't want to actually know how tall Sheik is, but like, Davos, right now. How tall is Sheik?
Taller than a fox, as you'd hope with a human.
Yeah, Luna's pretty short, and she kind of looks like fox.
Yeah, but she's a dog, mate.
Yeah, that's true. 8 foot? Yeah, I reckon Sheik's a lean 6'7".
She's probably pretty similar to like Captain Falcon, I reckon.
Yeah, but she's got those limbs.
Yeah.
His torso's just huge.
He's got long limbs too. Have you seen those acrobat?
Yeah, like, no, but Captain Falcon's been on the trend, bro. He's a beefcake.
You're saying he's dehydrating?
I'm saying
to get his weight down.
Yeah, absolutely.
How heavy is Sheik? That's a better question. How heavy is Sheik?
I'm gonna say 110 pounds.
110 pounds.
Like 50 kilos.
That's 50 kilos. Yeah. I'm gonna say 145 pounds.
Okay, fair enough.
I think Sheik could do well in the featherweight division of the UFC.
I reckon Sheik could be a fiend in UFC. She's a grappler.
She's a everything. She is a true mixed martial artist.
She is. Gotta respect it.
Yeah, bro.
Davin's losing.
Yeah, Musket, consistent, man.
Musket, a gamer. Davin, slick with it, though. Oh, that is the wrong time to say that. That was the wrong time.
He was never slick to begin with.
First of all, Davin's silky smooth. Second of all,
he's
getting owned right now.
He's getting owned?
Davin's
getting kind of looking good, though.
Censored word owned.
I don't know why, but Davin wears like jumpers in the most disgusting heat. It's like 34 today.
It's the clammiest gamer funk room right now.
When we're in Melbourne on the Thursday, owned. On the Thursday, it was so hot, and he's wearing a fucking jeans and a jumper.
Davin!
Yeah, he needed it.
He heard me. Davin's winning this game.
Davin never tries game one anyway. Yeah, it's well known.
Everyone knows Davin's a sandbagger.
See, you know he's sandbagging when he's not. Oh. See, he's just going for the most retarded.
I've got a bit of paper bag in my yop.
No, that's good luck.
Paper bag in your yop is good luck?
Yeah.
All right. I feel like that's when you tell a kid getting shat on by a bird is good luck. Because okay. They just got shat on by a bird. All
right, you got me. Getting paper bag in your yop is not good.
It's definitely not good luck. Yeah, Davin's winning. Davin's winning. Davin's not winning.
Every time you try to say something good about him, he's losing.
Davin's a scrambled man right now.
Oh, a bit wacky going on right now.
Davin's been on a low to medium heat for 5 to 7 minutes. He's looking a bit scrambled right now.
Is Danny Tai's Bistro one of those like Thai places where you go, hey, I want medium heat, and they... Well, to me anyway, it's the spiciest shit you've ever had. Even spicier than like the spicy Doritos.
I've never had a spicy Dorito.
It's not spicy. It's not Cheetos. Doritos, they look like them. Muska would know what I'm talking
about.
Oh,
those spicy chips?
Yeah, like there's a great picture of Muska.
Yeah, yeah, nearly vomiting near a bin.
Yeah, spitting in the Hindley Street bin. It's a good look.
One of his brightest moments, I'd say.
Yeah. He showed a lot of character in that moment.
He showed a lot of development in that chip eating procedure.
Yeah, he's saying, hey, Davin, Thai medium curry, more like mild curry.
Yeah. Woo! Muscat, let's just say he handles the heat well.
Yeah, he's handling the spicy hot heat of Davin very well right now. Oh, Davin. Davin's going for the worst reads. Like, okay, if he's hitting the reads, all right, you're dope, but we all know he's a reaction man, and he's gone for reads, and they're not
Yeah,
hitting.
But look at that. That was clean. That was efficient.
Yeah, that's his bread and butter.
That's the Davin one, too, really.
What's the Thai equivalent of bread and butter? That's your tasty laksa, right?
That's your coconut rice and curry.
Yeah, okay.
Bit of dead air, not gonna lie. Bit
dead air. I mean, that
Muscat's
it happens.
Just man. Winning, bro.
Doing nothing fancy. Just like we said, handling the heat.
Back like Charlie Sheen in the early 2010s. He's just hashtag winning.
Hashtag winning? Yeah.
Yeah. My mom says hashtag winning.
Like she says the hashtag?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's awesome.
I love saying hashtag things. Or .gov.
.gov.
I love adding .gov to obscene things.
Yeah, all right. It's last stock. One stock to one.
Yep.
Davin on 69% .gov.
Yeah, exactly. It's last stock .gov.
Oh, okay. You had a double joke.
.sa.edu. Muscat providing a bit of the edu right there.
Davin can't keep up.
Muscat saying, this is my court. We play by my rules. You know when you're at your friend's...
He's got no choice.
You're at your friend's house when you're young and you're playing his video game, but you don't really want to play, and he's like, no, we're playing this game because it's my house, my rules.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's what Muscat's doing to Davin right now.
Muscat's playing the game. Davin's the friend watching in the background, wanting a turn, but he's not getting allowed
Muscat's
a turn.
Muscat's playing Ocarina of Time, and Davin's controlling Navi.
Yeah. That's right.
With a second controller. No, look, you're doing so good as the ferryman.
Yeah.
I couldn't do this without you.
Oh my God.
The ferry strikes back.
He's found out he's not playing. He's striked Muscat.
he's unplugged Muscat's controller.
he's trying to strangle him with the N64
cord. In a brutal rage, Davin sees only red.
Oh my God, he's actually destroying him right now. He's going to choke him out.
Davin's off the grid, that's for sure.
Bloody hell, okay. Muscat can't get it started now. This is where Davin actually tries.
This is yummy percent. Yeah, Davin said, I'm going to stop sandbagging now that I'm down 2-0.
Yeah.
It's like an idiot. Did you hear Will D triple four stock me?
I heard that. He also 3-0'd you 3 times in one set.
When?
Today.
That's like a triple four stock, bro.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, oh my.
Are you joking?
Okie jokey.
Mate.
Yeah, everyone knows Muscat's got it like that.
Yeah.
He's just eating him up.
Oh, he needs this edge guard. Good reactions. Just strong hit of the back air too.
Muscat's just he's feeling it right now.
No, I hope so.
He's going to ask to eat at Danny's later. That's all I'm going to say.
That was a crazy shot.
He's the cleanup crew.
Upbeat, not invincible enough.
He's just doing work. Let me grab you with my little fox hands. Oh,
okay. What's he going to do? Oh, that was tricky.
I could never have predicted that in my life.
Oh. It's looking real rough for Davin right now. Alright, I was lying. Davin was never trying this set.
Davin's never tried before.
Alright. Very clean 3-0.
Very clean.
Muscat. Absolutely rolling.
Muscat showing winning gaming once again. Dominating the local SA scene.
This is why he was seated second and Davin was seated third. Even though Davin got third at the Australian Invitational. Not
Davin's a sleeper.
Yeah.
Davin's a sleeper.
Absolutely.
Agent.
Who we got now? I hope it's not me. I hope we got someone else.
Yeah, I just want to chat with my boy for a bit.
Just give me one more set. Sure, put the other losers game on.
You calling them losers, bro?
I'm a loser. I'm in the fucking losers bracket.
All of Melee's is the loser bracket, bro.
Yeah, at the end of the day, only one person is not in the loser's bracket, and they might still be in there.
I don't even know what that means. Getting philosophical with me, man.
It's philosophical
Kai,
and practical.
Are you playing Kai?
I hope not. I hope Kai goes into the ring with Catherine or something. No one's told me anything yet.
Oh, he's nodding. He's nodding.
Yep. F5.
Oh, he said press F5.
Okay. I was like, hey. Press F5 and game me.
It is Kai and Catherine.
Oh, well, let's go. Kai likes to
be... Wait, press F7. I don't know what it does, but I want to know now. The boys.
That's me. Hey. No, we'll leave it on us for a bit.
Yeah, they want to see us. They want to see the boys.
They want to
see
the boys.
Muscat and Jeff.
And they also want to see Catherine.
Muscat
and
Jeff. We're keeping it real.
Muscat and Jeff?
Yeah, both of us.
Yeah.
We're both Muscat and Jeff.
Shotgun Muscat.
Fuck!
Yeah. Alrighty.
These kind of match the singlet I got on right now.
The Nola?
Yeah,
oh,
Nola.
Oh, yeah.
Maybe.
Nice, nice,
Chris
nice.
Chris Paul, represent.
I don't want to represent him, though.
Well, that's fair enough. He's a little angry old man.
All right, who is the commentary team? Nang. And Nangs.
Can you put me under Will D?
No.
Cutest comms I've ever seen. Thanks, Dean.
Okay. No, I can. I lied.
I'm Will D now?
Nangs and Will D. Here to commentate.
They do call me Will
good.
D.
Very good match. All right, you're not going to see us anymore.
And you're not going to see this brown paper bag either.
Oh, they're right into it.
We got a yop on us. I'm not going to lie.
Oh, shit. How do we switch the cameras? There we go. Let's go. All right, we're into it. What a gimp.
Gimp?
I saw it.
Look at Kai sliding across the screen.
Yeah, he's
wave
sliding.
Dashing, IRL. Can't give him a quick 1-2 though.
Yeah, good to bring him back.
Smack him in the face.
I think Kai.
Okay, you go.
Oh yeah. Oh, he is.
Nick's correcting us. We had a 3 there. It's actually a 0-0 right now.
We've placed up.
He's on top of it.
Yeah, I thought I was on sports bet with the Catherine 3-0.
Yeah.
I'm actually. It's actually 0-0 IRL right now.
Yeah, so true. How do we feel about Falco's bones? Because he's a bird, they're hollow, right?
Oh, yeah.
So he's pretty easy opponent, I'd say.
He's pretty light.
Yeah. I think,
Yeah, Peach has the full density bones as a trait being a human.
Peach also grew up quite privileged, probably had access to milk.
You'd hope so.
I feel like she's definitely got high calcium levels. She's breaking this bird down.
Maybe she skipped the milk and spent all her pocket money on mushrooms.
I don't blame her then. Maybe that's why it... I don't know. I haven't got another Mario joke.
Yeah.
I'm done with that.
Mario's not our expertise.
Yeah.
Except that he looks funny. And that's all.
He looks so silly. He's got all such a bulbous nose.
It is quite bulbous.
It is. Falco doing some work in. Getting some 42% off of a hit.
That's good.
That's what you like to see. Against Peach, you want at least 40% per hit.
Yeah. I feel like Catherine doesn't like the attrition game.
Which is a shame, which her character does.
And Kai loves playing that.
So do I. No, I'm dumb. I can't do it. I shoot two lasers every time.
Yeah.
If you've ever played me, I shoot two lasers and do a high dare.
I mean, like, it can work sometimes, man.
Yeah, I know.
Oh my god. Grab edge.
No single Peach in the universe knows how to grab edge.
That's right. Oh, forward throw. Trying to go for a DI mix-up or some shit.
Dead.
That sucks. Catherine could be up stuck.
You hate to see it.
She just didn't do the good thing.
But she's going to get a down smash. It's going to be 36%.
Catherine's good at like picking out the ledge option there.
Kai's good at not getting down smash right now.
Oh my god.
Oh, there it is.
There it is.
It was not 36%.
It's airborne. That's huge, that dare not hitting. Oh my god, the movement's sick.
Kai sliding.
The movement's sick.
Much like his real life avatar, Kai sliding.
I don't get it, but let's go.
You were moving right before.
Spot dodge down smash into a dash attack near edge guard. That's how I'm predicting that edge is set.
I think it's just going to be a big strong back air to close
from
out
the
game.
Bird. No way.
Those
bones are meant to be hollow, man.
Yeah, he's got metal feet, though, to make up for it. It's good compensation. I don't know anything about it.
No, I truly forgot about that. Yeah, that makes a lot more sense. Otherwise, their bones would, like, truly be brittle. Oh, my God. What have I done to Catherine?
But surely he just, like, jumps and dies. What about his knees? What about his birdie knees?
I don't know.
I don't know how it works.
Have you seen birds' feet in real life?
Yeah.
They're just sticks.
They are just sticks.
They got no meat on them or anything.
He's wearing a jacket as well. Who knows what's in there?
No, that. Who knows?
He could have an arsenal of goodies.
What kind of goodies?
Robitussin. Oh, is that dead? Oh, I would have shined and it wouldn't have killed.
Same.
Glad we're on the same page.
Oh my god.
I did that to McLeod once, just and it was dominating. Obscene, and it killed him, and neither of us believed it.
Is that when he was playing Luigi?
It was when he was playing Yoshi.
Yoshi?
Yoshi.
Oh no,
that's a rare miss. I heard he lost to you today. In a game 5 set.
He did.
With Captain Falcon.
And my boys weren't there to cheer me on.
Who warmed your Captain Falcon up? I'm just curious. Was it your boys?
Yeah, I think it was Lord TF2.
I wish I knew that guy. I'm just a humble Will D, so.
Yeah. He's pretty cool.
Will D's so humble.
Oh my.
See? See, did I not call it before?
Yeah.
Kai's onto it.
You did mention something about a shine to shine combo killing off the top.
Yeah, and I called the back air before. I'm profit. Kai's,
yeah, I mean,
Kai's
like,
doing to Catherine what Will D did to me earlier today.
This is brutal.
If I'm Kai, I'm just doing a dare and another dare.
Catherine,
hoping for the best.
I'm avoiding the four stock, then running off the edge. Alright.
The floor stock?
I mean, Catherine has had four stock comebacks before, though. Against
Muscat.
Against Lemons.
Against Lemons?
Oh my god, she could just do it here.
I'd really like for her to do it here. That'd be a
oh my god, she just keeps
scoring.
Getting the first hit.
Oh my god!
Is she gonna get this edge guard?
Catherine's nasty with
oh
it!
Oh my god.
And just like that, it seems doable.
It's doable.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's doable.
Nah, I still should have run off the edge.
Yeah.
Nah, just kidding.
With Honor?
Let's go.
Yeah, she's looking for something. Ooh. Nah, that's okay. She got hit by a dash attack. Sorry, a get up attack. That's not a real neutral win.
Awesome.
Kai has yet to win neutral.
Oh my god.
Kai has yet to win neutral. Kai has yet to win neutral.
Oh my god.
Ladies and gentlemen, you're watching this. 700 neutral wins in a row. Okay, there we go.
Only down is.
He wins
okay,
one.
No,
he wins
that's
one
fine.
Neutral.
That's fine.
If Catherine keeps playing like that, it's closed curtains.
Yeah, if Catherine keeps making Kai choke, it could be good for her.
Yeah.
Someone in chat doesn't know who Will D is.
Will
can
D?
You can you tell can you tell the chat a bit about yourself?
I'm a really aggressive, smart, fundamental thinking Peach player from South Australia. And yeah. I'm super cool, humble, and the ladies love me. Thank you. That's all.
That is everything I've heard about Will D. And
everything
more.
And more.
And more.
I would have done the same thing, Kai. And it wouldn't have worked the same way.
It's another strong start for Kai. Mm. Oh, he's chilling on the
strong
top.
Strong start for a strong man.
That's what I did against McLeod. I just viciously, platform camped him on FOD.
I did that with, I was trying to time out Will D, I'm not going to lie. I was just running around with Fox trying to time him out.
Time out yourself, you're saying.
Yeah.
That's right.
It's like in a game of tennis, PPMD taught me that one. I'm a reader. I love reading. My name's Will D.
Will D is oh my god.
Will D's read so many books.
Oh, Catherine needs to clean this up quick.
Yeah. Catherine plays her best on her last up, unfortunately.
Oh, yeah. No jump.
That's a freebie. We like that.
Yeah, we like that. Not having to, clean up the edge guard. That's always a nice thing to do.
I can see Catherine taking the stop right now.
Yeah, me too.
I actually don't even can. I do see it.
Kai not even SDing that much this set. So that, usually when you play Kai, at least one game you'll be up 4 stocks to 3 just all of a sudden. But not today.
I'm not sure if that's is that a good thing?
Not for Kai, but for everyone else, yeah.
But he's not doing it
today. Oh, really good. Oh my god, what's he doing right now?
He's got hits on hits!
Oh my god.
Catherine pressed the A button.
It was a good choice to press that A button.
Yeah, she probably learned that from Luigi Man himself.
Alright. Nice, that could be it. Oh, missed the shooter up.
Okay. Oh, nice. Hit him with Mr. Saturn!
Oh. The South Australian sniper right there. Good back air. That's it.
Good back air. That's it. What's the type of commentary I want to hear about?
Is it McLeodian?
Is it you and McLeodian?
I might not even be playing next.
When are you playing?
Who knows?
Are you in winners right now? No, you just lost to Nick.
Yeah, I lost to Nick. He owned me.
Yeah, but you'll get him next time, right?
Mm-hmm. I really want to lean back, but this court is super tight.
Lean back. Lean back. You know that song?
Yes.
You do regular the clubs.
I am a regular at the clubs.
I know. You should see this guy on a weekend.
Yeah. Give me a tip.
That guy right there, Davox?
Regular at Danny's Thai Bistro.
At Musket's feet right now.
Wait.
That sounds a bit weird, man.
It does sound
a bit lost. I've just been lost, man. Look at that whole rectangle
Holy
that
shit.
Man's got.
These guys are already playing? That's fucking crazy, bro. SA stacks.
Rectangle gamer. Zelda. They're playing for, I don't know. I honestly don't know what game it is. Losers
it's
semis?
Winners it's not.
Losers
I'm just going to put in losers.
Zelda. Yeah. You're just going to call them losers?
Yes.
Not with us on screen, please.
No, no, it won't come up yet.
Okay.
It'll come up when they're playing.
Thank God.
Saved there.
Oh.
I want to put my head back.
I'm so warm. I just want to eat some food, man.
We were literally just... See, we should have gone to ramen.
Well, we will, for dinner.
Yeah, but it closes at 8:30. It's already 7:22.
All right, well then, sandbag.
Looks like we're going to Sky food. City. And it's not...
Well, it wasn't open. The ramen wasn't open, bro.
Yeah, but the... there's more than... There's plenty of ramen places.
We tried two.
Not while I was there.
Yeah, I wasn't there
I was
either.
Checking suggestions, you know.
Left, right,
out the,
center.
Out the wazoo.
Left, right, center.
Out the wazoo.
You suggested one place.
I suggested Austral.
Yeah. Did you?
I did. I suggested...
Well, you can still go to the Austral. Are you upset now?
No, I'm slightly happier that you said that, actually. We could still go to the Austral.
Yeah, I'm down for the Austral.
I hate it. I hate it.
Put that on the screen.
I suppose. Oh shit! We haven't done the names.
You forgot the names.
Oh my god. Guys, don't read. Don't read the name.
Whatever you do right now, don't read the name.
Please do not read them.
Ignore the names and the 3-0 on the screen.
Please, this isn't Kai. This isn't Catherine.
No matter what information you may see, do not believe it. Stay blind.
There you go. Wonderful. Oh my god, he's still up 3-0.
Yeah.
That's not true.
I guess what, we just
guys,
erased
not, I really don't want to lie.
We
to
just
you.
Erased all three of his wins, like just like that.
See, and we get the losers up the top. That was always accurate.
Whoa.
Oh my.
Davin my.
Oh my.
Davin my.
Not going on stage against Peach, that's a big one. I'm just going to center McLeod a bit more on the cam. Wrong way.
Look at him go.
Wow, McLeod actually destroying because... These guys played at Melbourne at the GG Easy League, and it was not close.
As in Davin's way, or...?
Davin's way.
Was McLeod playing on his rectangle?
Yeah. He was a rectangle gamer, and... It didn't do him any favours. Well, maybe it did, but not results.
This game seems to be a little bit different. Especially with that Raditz he's throwing. Peach is so crafty with those vegetables.
She's crafty.
You never know which one she's going to pluck.
Neither does she.
I don't know.
That's the beauty of farming, actually. You never know what you're going to get.
That reminds me of that one video, that image of the guy who's like super proud of his huge watermelon. And he opens it up and it's a cucumber.
Wait, what?
It's a really fucking huge cucumber.
What? How? Cucumbers are long and skinny.
I'll show you the video later.
Like
the image,
a
sorry.
Watermelon is
bro,
almost
trust me.
Perfectly round.
I would have thought it was a watermelon as well.
Watermelon,
I'm going to get up for chat.
Watermelons are a sphere.
I'm going to get up for chat.
Cucumbers
gonna
are a
I'm going to Google watermelon cucumber and you're going to be baffled.
No way. No way. I don't believe you. Alright. Davin bringing it back. And this is the bread and butter. I mean, the yellow coconut rice.
Look how big that is.
As if! That does look like a...
It does look like a watermelon.
It kind of looks like a bit of an irregular watermelon, but...
Yeah, it just looks like... No, but
it does look like a watermelon.
It's a custom homegrown watermelon.
Yeah, imagine it being a fucking cucumber. That sucks ass.
Maybe in between, in between games, we can show this cuke.
Bro, those cucumber circles are like frisbees, honestly.
Medallions.
That'd be a big-ass medallion.
I looked away for like 10 seconds. Davin's won the game.
Me too. I was looking at a large cucumber. I thought it was a watermelon.
I guess they're just getting straight back into it. How do you feel about the Smashbox?
I don't know anything about it.
Do you think it's a fair gaming moment?
Not really. But it's like better for your wrists, and I don't want to say, hey, you got bad wrists, you can't play, you know?
Do you think when mankind is over and we're all computers, they'll play on boxes?
They're
playing brain box.
They're gonna have rectangle brains and playing with them.
Is that because they watch too much TV growing up?
No, that's eyes, bro.
Yeah, sorry.
That's eyes.
That's my bad. My bad, everyone.
I got square eyes.
Yeah, because you're a gamer. You're a certified gamer.
I'm a meleeer.
Isn't that what that is?
No.
What's the difference? Can you tell me?
Pretty much the only game I play.
That's the game.
I would play Halo, but it's fucking 343 are doing some shit, and I don't want to get into it. But
what does that mean?
It means the developers are bad.
Oh, no. I was enjoying it.
Me too. I chucked a cheeky,
I'm going to say, 50 hours into Halo.
Yeah, I chucked a cheeky 70, and I just can't handle it anymore.
Okay. That's a shame.
And I've put hundreds into the other ones. Oh my god.
These guys are just trading one hit for one hit for one hit for one hit.
Alright.
This is how floaties do it.
Still not dead. Drop it. Nice. No tech.
Genius.
Genius.
Genius on stupid?
Got the tech chase. I like it. Davin somehow reversed that.
I have no clue how. Davin's got a slimy player.
Yeah.
Before you know it, he's slipped and he's slider and he's beating you. That's what happened last game.
He's a slimy player?
Yeah, he is.
That sounds like corrupt or something.
He is corrupt.
Yeah, go on. I'm listening.
Politically, socioeconomically, and I don't know. I just don't trust the guy.
Yeah. You reckon he's going to get into politics and then put a random... grant in,
for himself?
Yeah, I think a restaurant.
At the bare minimum, he spat my food.
The restaurant rebate, the Thai restaurant rebate that he's gonna.
Yeah. The Thai restaurant census.
Man.
He's gonna hit him with another back air. No, he's not.
That's more of a Russian oligarch strategy, to be fair.
No, but he's a bit of a Russian sheik, I'd say.
Russian sheik.
Yeah.
Don't know what that looks like.
Have you ever seen a rush goalie?
No.
Watch more
Tell
soccer.
Me more.
Watch more soccer.
Absolutely not.
Alright, I'll leave it at that then. Do you reckon this Cloud's gonna get involved in these antics?
Not yet. Yeah, I think he's wanting to join in, but he's just being a little bit excluded right now.
They're playing 1v1 right now and not 2v1 like they should be.
This might be it. Oh, good tech. Oh, he might get a kill here.
Nah, Randall's about to come out. Oh, never mind. Okay, Randall is yet to come out.
Oh, this is a rough spot.
I'm wondering where
back
that buddy is right
here.
Now.
Oh, so he knew the timer. He knew the timer, but he missed it.
Noob.
Noob. Yeah, get your execution good first.
He was playing a 0v2 right there.
Yeah. Oh.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Would you take Davin to FD right now?
I would not. I would. All right. I think it's a good choice. I like it better than
He's smacking him.
Yoshi's.
Why are you say? You say Yoshi?
Yeah.
The dinosaur? Yoshi?
Yeah, Yoshi.
Yoshi?
Yoshi's Yoshi. Fully American, man.
No, he's not. He's a dinosaur.
No, saying it as Yoshi is fully American.
All right. Well, how do they say it in Japan?
Yoshi.
Yoshi.
Don't say yo.
Yo.
They don't say that.
You reckon they don't say yo in Japan?
No.
Alright. I'll take your word for it.
I thought you learned your hiragana, man.
I did.
Yeah.
They definitely do say yo.
It's not
yo.
It's not R-E-U-E-O.
It's ya-yi-yu-yo.
Yeah, it's ya-yi-yu-yo.
Yeah! That's a soldier boy.
Soldier boy tell.
Speaking of Soldier Boy, Davin Mai, I don't know. I don't know where I was going with that, but Davin Mai's winning. Young Soldier Davin.
Yeah, he's soldiering on.
He is.
Oh my, that one was
through the wire.
All right, good edge guard.
Was it though? I mean, he got the job done.
Maybe
he did get the job done.
Maybe Davin's recovery's bad.
Yeah, I'd
agree. And I do think
one.
It could have used some improving. Be a bit more tricky.
But isn't Cheeks like super linear no matter what?
Not. Kind of, but like, you got some tricks you can do.
Oh my god, he's about to saber him.
Yeah, judge it. Oh, fuck. I thought I had like no end lag. Oh, he's taking the beam sword with him.
To hell.
I'm taking this to space.
He's taking the beam sword.
I'm taking it
straight
to someone's
going to
use it.
To space?
Yeah.
Vicky McLeod just invented Star War.
He invented a Star War?
Yeah.
Alright, you might.
He might have. You don't know. And he's taking that secret with him.
He's taking the secret of the saber with him. I will agree with that.
McLeod smack. Wait, oh, no, that's the wrong guy I'm talking about. Davox is smacking McLeod in the face.
This is a big moment for, for McLeod.
This is a comeback moment.
Oh.
Not like that, though. You don't come back like that.
He's got to keep center stage. All right, that's real good for McLeod.
Sure about that?
Yeah, well, like, if you recover and then somehow end up in the center of FD, like, you're loving life.
You're doing well. You live loving laughing.
Like, he doesn't get hit and he gets the position, like... Drop it? Oh, he threw it.
Coward.
Everyone knows...
You got a Z, drop it.
Yeah, so you're just saying... Say things like Americans, like Z and Z.
Wait, you say Z?
Yes.
That's not a letter. I guess it is the letter. The letter actually is Z, right?
Yeah, bro. Where did you grow up?
Adelaide. I lived in Canada for like 3 years.
Yeah, you grew up in... Yeah, exactly. You grew up in Canada. And...
Aren't they just like... Whatever.
Yeah.
Whatever, man. Do you say Zed dropping?
Yes.
No, you don't.
Yes, I do.
Oh, my God. That's just ignorant at that point.
How so?
Who named it?
Who named what?
Surely Americans came up with Z dropping.
What do you mean? It's hitting the...
It's named Z.
It's just dropping with the Z, which is the
I'm
only...
Not, I'm never calling it Zed dropping in my life. That's too hard to say. Do you pronounce the D? Zed? Dropping?
Who are you, mate?
Somebody that wants to say Z, bro.
Go back to Canada, man.
Maybe wow. I thought Australia was supposed to be multicultural, bro.
Not
here.
Yeah.
Wow, not this couch.
Damn, what are you... Oh,
taking it 3-0.
3-0. That box.
The rectangle, not helping McLeod this time. Maybe next time.
I'm up.
I want to leave.
Thank you for listening to us ramble.
I'm alone now. I want Will D to be up here. I want Will D. I'm alone. I'm alone. I need somebody here with me. I need a co-commentator, I'm afraid. Davin. I'm getting Will with me. I need to figure out what these buttons do. I don't know which one's the screen. This one's the screen.
How's it going?
Look, there's Will D.
Hello.
And that makes me now Jeff. Oh, no, sorry, I'm... Yeah. Will D and Jeff.
Yep, good work.
All right, we need to change this. Oh, that's not how you spell his name. Why does it say Jamwa? Why is Nang's Jamwa?
Let's have Jamwa in.
I don't... Kai?
Why is Jamwa there?
Bang. And then we do one of these. Boom!
Nice.
Except Nangs doesn't exist and he's player four.
Yeah, reverse the camera somehow.
No, that's right. Kaizen Jamwa. What are you talking about? Why do I have to reverse the cameras?
Because Ruben's on the P4. Yeah, nice.
Oh, now I have to redo everything?
No, it's fine. No, it's good, right?
No, Kaizen.
Oh, fuck. Yeah,
you
that.
Ruined everything.
Sorry. Why is Jamwa there?
Oh, Kaizen. Look, there you go.
Cool. To work.
Everyone's happy.
Yep.
Classic incoming. Ruben versus Kaizen is a classic. You know what Ruben's going to do? Ready? Try to hit Kai. You know what Kai's going to do? Not try to hit Ruben. Pew, pew, pew.
Yeah, I don't know. That's a bit of a slug, right?
There we go. There's a hit. Into nothing. A lot of up tilts happening right now. I kind of respect it, though, because that's all I do.
Yeah. Seems kind of good against that, but eh.
What?
I
just think Ruben as a Samus. I know he's playing Captain Falcon right now, but I want to see the Samus. I feel like he usually beats Kai when he plays Samus. At least
yeah.
The recent times I watched it. I don't know about picking the character that's bad against Captain. sorry, against Falco.
He's just in a Falcon sort of mood.
Yeah, right. I disagree with it. Never mind. I fully agree with it. Agree with it.
Yeah.
I was a doubter. Will.
Yeah.
How you been, man?
I'm good. I'm kind of hungry, not gonna lie.
Yeah, I know. You know ramen closes at 8:30?
Why is this...
If Ruben loses right here, we can go get ramen.
Yeah, I'm down with that. I need to bring something up with the establishment that putting, you know, like, losers' quarters on the screen at 7:30 is questionable, but that's just my opinion.
And also making it best of five?
Yeah, fringe. But yeah, no, apart from that, good. How you been?
Yeah, right.
Some good games.
We watched Davin play, and I just creamed over Davin the whole time.
He was doing some things, yeah.
He was gaming. He was beating the Cloud. Cloud's using the rectangle. Davin, I'm not used to seeing that. I didn't know he was using it.
Yeah, for a while. I saw him with the Melbourne thing. Okay. And it's OP, I don't know.
Okay. They're screaming for Falcon, but he's losing.
Yeah.
I guess he's the underdog.
I also screamed for Falcon. Whoa, go Ruben.
Wait.
What?
Oh, okay. Never mind. You were saying you were screaming for Falcon, man.
I was getting there.
Alright. Kai putting in work. Kai about to make it a 3v1 stock game.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's up kind of bad.
Yeah, I think Ruben's swapping characters after this, to be honest.
Yeah, maybe he's like only playing Falcon all the time, though. I don't know.
I'd have to disagree. Unless Kai mad chokes.
Yeah, well,
this,
a bit like, I agree with you on the correct decision, but I don't want to get it. I assume he's going to play back on the whole time.
Nah. If Ruben loses, he'll swap.
You reckon? Okay.
Yeah.
I don't think so.
Alright.
We'll see.
Unless it's a close game. I can see Ruben staying.
Yeah, I don't know.
Shine grab as Falco is never seen in the world.
Yeah. Too hard.
Or at least I don't use it.
Yeah, that's what it does.
Because I never land a grounded shine.
Yeah.
Alright, let's see if Ruben swaps. Nope. I'm a liar, ladies and gentlemen.
Falcon mood, mate.
I'm a liar. I'm gonna click this one. Kai is up one game.
Yep.
KP Kaizen.
What is Z?
What do you mean? What is Z?
Yeah, Ruben's tag.
Oh, I was saying Z cancel and he was angry at me. I didn't even realize until now. I was saying Z cancel, he's like, no, it's Z. Do you say Z cancel? No. You're not a fucking moron. Do not say Z cancel. Do not tell me you say Z cancel. It's harder to say for no reason.
I'm going to have to give this one to you very begrudgingly.
Yeah.
I don't like to do
this. Ruben was like, nah, you're Australian. I'm like, no, it's just that they say Z cancel. They came up with the term.
It's objectively wrong, but yeah, like that's just what it is.
Yes. Exactly. It's a name for a thing. Therefore, it's fine.
Yeah.
Although I do like that the Z is winning now.
Yeah, true.
It's almost justifying his statement, to be honest.
Yeah, I think you have to eat your words, right? Don't need the fucking boop boop.
Flaoken. I don't like that he didn't do a down B. I feel like that's what he had to do there.
Yeah. Whoa. Insane.
This is insane. Ruben does that to me all the time.
Yeah.
And I have no clue how to get out of it.
It's not guaranteed, right?
I don't know. I mean, he's just kind of owning you a little bit.
Yeah.
He's limiting your options and then just playing around which ones he knows you're going to do.
Yeah.
Just a tiny little mix-up thing. Not saying I know anything about Melee.
That, good work. Yeah, I mean, same.
Side B to me. Yeah, that's a one-frame link.
True.
Campbell told me.
You don't have much time to
shout out to my boy Campbell. I hope he's somewhere safe, getting money back from Sora for his AB play.
Does he have a child now or something?
Yeah, he does.
Get that child.
Congratulations to Campbell.
I'm very keen to see him, yes.
I'm very keen to give him a hug.
Yeah.
I'm very keen to watch Ruben stomp Kai right now. Oh, almost.
Ah, it's a selection, bro.
Ruben loves to fall with a down air.
Yeah.
So do I, to be honest.
And like the short up down airs and stuff, out of like down out of shield.
Yeah. He does it because it beats like Shine and stuff.
Yeah, right. I think it's not that common of a thing, is it? I mean, probably I don't fucking know. Maybe.
It beats brain dead people like me.
Yeah.
That's probably why he does it.
Yeah, probably.
I would have kept chasing that. I don't know, right? Ruben didn't.
Yeah.
I guess he's just trying to play a bit cautiously. He's got the stock to work with. I think he's going to confidently clean that out.
Yeah, should wrap.
Here we go.
Oh, that was poor.
I would have up air.
That was poor.
Oh, Ruben. There's no way he chokes this. Right? Right?
Surely Ruben won't lose.
Surely Ruben doesn't choke these. Right?
Uh-oh.
Right?
Uh-oh.
Oh, you don't like to see it, but at the same time... Oh, there you go. That's game over.
Should be right.
Yeah. Tied game. Ruben's capped the Falcon, beating McLeod, taking the game off Kai.
What was the McLeod score?
It was game 5, last stop.
Damn. Oh, yeah, you mentioned that.
He got very sad.
Yeah.
It's one of those mango bananas. It's in the chat now. I don't know what to do with it. Put it in the organic waste, I guess.
I don't think Mangan's ever had a banana in his life.
He doesn't look like it.
No.
That man's funny. But he is. Anyways. On with the next.
It's just like
FD. FD, I think Falco wins hard on this stage.
I saw Big Marky beat someone, MSJ on this. That was pretty hard.
Yeah, though, but that's because he did some crazy
yeah.
knees.
I guess this says just more about reads and stuff, bro.
He strikes me as an apple and a mango kind of guy.
I cannot see mango eating a mango.
I cannot see mango eating fruit.
Maybe it was like wife like feeds him or something.
Maybe when he was a child.
Yeah.
Ruben unfortunately dropping his popping gamers there. What? What the fuck does that mean?
I'll take your word for it.
You know what? Woo! Sock's supposed to be a knowledgeable gamer. I'm sure he's dissecting Melee at a high level with that comment. Do you mean to ask? No. I didn't mean a what's poppin' gamers. What is poppin' gamers? If Captain Falcon wins this,
fair
nothing
enough.
Much, man. You? Damn, Kai, that was tasty. That was not tasty, but it got the job done.
I like your tournament runs at the, LA local stock. They're pretty hype, and it says like Falcos and stuff.
So, I have never watched you play other than when you beat Ruben, and I was
definitely
screaming
did.
The F word at you. I'm not gonna lie. You turned around and looked at the crowd, and I was like, I was screaming profanities. That's all I'm gonna say. But also, I was just screaming for my boy. No ill intent to stop, I guess. Until there's ill intent.
Just a game. Right.
That was so long ago. Bam's so fun. Can't wait for the new one. Wait for what set? The BAM. I don't know. The BAM one. Well, you turn around and look at the crowd, and I was like, man, this guy's beating up my boy bad.
That was the OG Nang Gang.
Yeah, Nang Gang. When he was still Atletico Sock. Very keen is BAM action again, aren't we? Oh,
yeah.
I was but a wee lad. It was only a couple years ago. Are you now a huge lad? Staunch lad? Very keen for some BAM action. So true. Everybody who's in the chat, come hit the cast with me when we're in. I will match everyone up to $200 on the roulette table who comes with me to the casino at BAM.
That's definitely a vibe.
Because it's like 50-50, right? I'll make it back.
Nah, if you believe hard enough, it's like 60-40.
Yeah, true. My way. Fun?
Oh,
yeah, true. Kai's up one game. Jeff really wanted to let us know. I'm about to be 20, so you're 19. So it's 3 years ago. Yeah, I guess. You can do a lot of growing from 16 to 19. I hope you are a huge unit now,
Oh, you
now,
can drink in America, though. That's lame.
That is lame. Next time.
Yeah, next time.
He probably did. Sock. What Sock gets up to in his own time, that's for no one to know.
Yeah, true.
I'll drop 2-2.
Okay, good work, good work.
If I go 2-2, I'll drop a fat skid at the crown. Yeah, okay, yeah, same. Can we all just get fucked up at crown, please? Been a mad lurker since the doc came out. Now that I'm a big boy working this time. Yeah, come
yeah,
on, man.
Mate.
This is my first event that I've come to in about a year.
Yeah, we've been a slack.
We have been slack, but come out. If we get enough numbers, I'll come and pop my head out more often.
It's just a lie, but we'll try our best.
Yeah, that's an absolute lie. Support the scene, it's
Whoa,
fun.
Whoa, that's cool.
Ruben,
woo!
A zesty gamer.
True.
Believe me, man, I drank in America.
Yeah. Well, I assume you did, God. But you know, like...
Sock's tough. Sock's tough like that.
At the bar and all that.
Probably pulling. I love Sock. Good on that, man. I bet America was so fun. Sock's naughty? Yeah, that's okay. He was born in the noughties. You know what I'm saying? 2000s?
I was going to Evo as like a 19-year-old. That was dark.
Evo as a 19-year-old? I think I was 19 when I went to Evo. But it was in Vegas and nobody asked because I'm like fucking 6'5".
Yeah, true. That helps.
I love you blokes already. Sick, man. Yeah. Thanks, we've got the yops on hand. We've got a couple drinks, maybe. Maybe we don't, depending on
allegedly
what the venue allows us to have here. It's all in the birth decades. Yeah, Zoomers, Boomers, whatever. We should be talking about the game. No, we shouldn't. I know nothing about this game.
Yeah, I reckon anything about 2000, that's a no-go, you know?
I'm 99. I'm safe.
Yeah, that's all right. Just...
I reckon Ruben should have died there. What's going to happen now? Are we about to get the swing of fate right here?
The flacken.
Is Kai choking this? Is Ruben about to get a juicy back air? Ruben.
Here's the move.
Ruben just needs one grab. Remember when they used to say that about Mewtwo King?
Yeah. Forward air him. Oh. Can't be doing that.
Oh.
GG's.
Good game to Kai. Held it together. Beat Ruben after a couple of slip-ups. Unfortunately, that means we're getting ramen. I need pee so bad.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Is it a handoff time or?
Does anybody want to go into comms? Not me. I was going to ask Nick, but I've noticed he's on the screen now.
True.
Nick versus Muscat, probably the most common set to have ever seen in EVAC ever, back in the day. Then it was Ruben versus Kai for years.
The classic was Muscat Ruben, surely. Muscat Ruben Kai.
Muscat Ruben Kai.
Nick was not a regular attendee.
Yeah,
I
but
think.
Back in the old days.
Yeah, you reckon?
In Boomer Adelaide Melee.
Yeah. When you were a wee baby.
I hope Donut's here.
Yeah, me too.
Nah, he would have commented in the chat if he was here.
He's too busy, like, building his house.
Does Nick win this?
I think so.
Do you want to change the names?
Yeah, I suppose.
Guys, predict down below what you think the scores are going to be in the video game chat, so I know that there's actual viewers here. It says 32 viewers on the stats, but I don't believe it. Give me your best Melee predictions. Nobody types in the chat. Cool. 3-1 Nick. That's Muska takes a game. That's always nice. Good to know J-Nuts is our only viewer.
Yeah,
you love to see it. No contest. Shout out to J-Nuts. Shout out to D's Nuts.
D's Nuts.
Have you changed? Oh, you have changed the names. You have changed this as well.
I don't know the button.
Dipshit. And is it right? Yeah, it's right. And Nick's up 70?
Oh, what a hero.
70-1? J-Nuts was very wrong.
Muscat's J-Nuts got, catching up to
this. Got that Muscat got one game right. Reports to T.O. 71, but it was close though.
Like, I can't put decibels in. I want to, like...
Decibels? Like sound level?
Why has Kai got the setup so he can't control? What is this?
Muscat's going to have to watch out for Nick's big muscles. I don't know, he's bouldering. I think that's lean muscles.
Yeah.
They're the secret muscles. 3-0 man's got the K, yeah, the M95.
Huh?
Kai's hijacking our TV.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it's no longer, they're no longer losers. We're looking at the winners here. Yeah, but yeah, as you'll quickly notice, Nick doesn't actually have them wrapped around his ears. Fun fact, that works less than a surgical mask, man. But we won't talk about that. Non-conservationist Nick, question marks? Mask rubbing us of Nick's facial expressions? No, don't worry, you can still see it. You can see his tongue poking in there.
I don't like this anti sort of mask thing Musk has going off. Yeah, he's a non-believer.
Is he?
Oh.
Who cares?
Yeah. It's a myth anyway, right? Who cares?
Look, if you touch your mask, I'm wearing one, but
yeah.
If you touch it, it's compromised.
It doesn't work, right? I have heard the same thing.
It's compromised. In a hospital, they tell me to change it every single time you touch it, every single time you do anything, no matter if you're sanitized or anything. And you can't wear a mask for over an hour. You're going to get changed.
So
if you sneeze or cough in one of these, it doesn't matter. You've already compromised it. So what does it do?
Completely compromised?
Placebo, basically. Because you're breathing through it, it's still getting the particles through your mask.
Yeah, but like, does it like reduce effectiveness? Or just
probably, but it's still just like...
Yeah.
We're just trying to do what the legislation tells us.
Yeah.
I'm not anti, I'm not whatever. I'll wear my mask.
I think it's good on like buses and stuff, but
I don't want to talk about Melee mask talk anymore. I want to talk about Muscat hitting an epic up smash.
Oh.
Population Muscat. Afghanistan. Okay.
The mega move.
That's up 1-0. Is Kai... Updated score! It just changed, you fuck! I'm not gonna swear at this guy, but Jeff's really testing me.
We got some,
I'm gonna ban Jeff from the next evac. I don't have that power.
Call a vote.
I do not have that power.
Jeff's being
and plus, this guy's an evac supporter, much more than I am, so.
Yeah, we don't even go.
Yeah. And yet here I am, commentating something I know nothing about. Whoa. What I do know is that's a dead fox.
Yeah, you can't be DI'ing that way.
The only time I know to do that is at 55%. And every fox knows to DI straight up for that.
Yeah.
So I have to get a pivot grab and it does nothing. I think. I don't know if Flo does. I'm not gonna pretend like I do. Double grab of the edge. That's a math special. Didn't get punished for your first grab, won't get punished for your second one. Will get some insane follow-ups though.
Like going down low is a bit risky, but you gotta go for it, I guess. Why not?
Zam? I never understood why there's a Z. Like Zam and Zaddy? Can you explain to me that, Will? I feel like you'll know.
That seems like your sort of thing, like.
I think it's your forte.
Oh, yeah.
Anyone? Anybody here a TikToker? Does anybody like TikTok in the chat? No?
I don't like that. It's a curse. Anyone here a TikTok? I am trying to hear that.
You have TikTok on your phone?
No.
Don't lie to me. Will, don't lie to me.
Like, I'll open them if someone sends me a funny one.
He
but
has,
it's not on my
he
phone.
Has TikTok. The fact that you said I'll open one means
no, like on Messenger, you know, like the
yeah,
the
sure.
I'm
sure.
Old, like I say.
Any ZAM 12 attendees? I'll definitely be a BAM 12. I'm not gonna pretend like it's a ZAM 12. Big ZAM. Big ZAM's a Gundam. It's a big one.
There you go.
Believe it or not, it's a big green one without arms.
I did not know that.
McLeodian. Hey, McLeod. Well, not if that's. I guess that's not McLeod's name. Maybe it is. I think Nick's about to win there. Yeah. That's the up tilt you wanted, Marv. Ready? Whoa. Jeff's gonna yell update the score in a second. It's like we're playing Uno with Jeff. He just. We didn't say Uno on our last card. Is Nick about to be on winner's side grand finals? I could not have guessed this. Did you write winner's finals Pog?
Yeah, it's a Pog champ, dude.
Okay, true.
Pog.
Why do they just stand still for a second there? I heard no dash dancing going on.
Oh, that's like the top level gameplay. You both affect us so much, man.
Nick knows when to effer tip smash.
He does the mega move, very mega-y, you know.
Anybody who goes to BAM, I'm telling you right now, we're hitting the cash together. You want to be there for that. It's going to be a miserable night. And then we'll hit the food court and cry about all our losses later. But it's okay, because they take all our money.
True.
Meet me at the cast.
You got a phantom?
Am I going to phantom? No, hey, fuck no.
Okay. Why not though, right?
Sydney?
Yeah. True.
I
want
to go to Sydney.
Don't want to go to any liberal government sort of states, you know?
No, I want to go. I do like Sydney. I just, I could probably make it out to one melee event a year, and I've already chosen Cheese League, and so I'm stretching it for two.
That's fair.
I might as well make it BAM, right? BAM for the Foursquare. I'll have you kids know that you guys think you're tough at Foursquare, but you ain't ever seen me. You ain't ever seen me in the squares.
I think you're too tall for it.
No. It's like, bro, I have unlimited reach. And you best believe when I'm king, the jank rules come out. I'm telling you right now, I'll straight up fuck up any of you at Foursquare. Those Americans think that they were tough at it? Ooh. They didn't see me and Kevin Rudd grinding. Shout out to K-Rudd, the Foursquare god.
Yeah.
Nick might win this set. I'm just going to say it. Oh my god, they're terrible? Yeah, of course they are, bro. They didn't know it like us. Vegemite sandwiches. Foursquare. That was my lunch.
What do Americans do, like, on the playground?
Try not to get shot.
Yeah, it's true.
In Texas, apparently, they've reallowed guns in schools.
What, to, like, kids, or...?
I don't know. I just read an article that I know nothing about out of context.
Oh! That was
like
pretty
that,
sick.
And just like that, I've unfortunately,
Yeah, that
talk,
was
talk some, bullshit over a super sick combo.
That was some good gameplay. We had the math moves. They worked well.
Kai's updating everything for us because we're ignorant, stupid
you guys
idiots.
Didn't need to do this.
That's
yeah,
good.
And yet.
No, I need to do this. What's up, dude?
Then why are you doing it? You don't have to do it either.
That sounds like someone else's job.
Yeah, it sounds like Flowey's job.
Let's go, Devin.
There's empty chairs.
What is this game?
And Win here's
it?
The boys.
Is this losers something?
I think Kai and Davin are about to play in winners. Oh no, this is still losers. Yeah, losers finals. Wow.
Whoa.
Nah, I lost 400 at the cast, bro. I tell you right now, we go together. You'll win 400.
How much does Slime lose when he went? That's what I want
to
know.
All I know is I approached Slime after he went to the cast.
He didn't seem very happy.
Crown. And I was like, oh my god, you're Slime. This is like a couple years ago.
Yeah.
And he was like, yeah. And I was like, how you feeling, man? And I realized he was walking out of Crown and like absolute like horribly down bad.
I've heard those guys are they're pretty big gamblers.
Why not? But also...
Yeah.
That's why.
It seems weird that, like, Mango's, like, thousands of fans just go towards him losing on black.
No, but that's sick. That's the way it should be, to be honest.
True.
if professional athletes are going to get paid the numbers they do, then I think Slime should be paid the numbers he does.
Oh, yeah, I mean, Slime should definitely be paid the big
Slime
bucks.
Should get paid big, big bucks. I love that man.
Yeah.
Or at least what I know of that man.
Yes, his moments.
Okay, J-Nuts, because you're the only person in the chat, who's winning this game? Pro tip, it's Davin.
Yeah, I'm on the Davin train.
We haven't swapped the things yet.
Whoopsie.
I need a piss so bad.
Oh no.
Fuck. Fuck!
You can do it.
Oh, they're doing hand warmers anyways.
Yeah, lame.
Lame.
Try to battlefield, boys. Come on. Oh, the David's coming
out. Kaiser versus David. Who's gonna win? No one knows. Davin, the Mad Ox, Davox. Yeah. But Davin's actually a filthy sandbagger. I'm not saying that if Kai wins this, I'm not discrediting it, but Davin's just a bum. What happened to Davin? Who's this David guy? He looks steezy? He does not look steezy. Yeah, okay, the Tommy Hilfiger guy. Maybe he's a little steezy, but you gotta think about how clammy this room is. It takes away everything. This room is like 40% humidity. I'm pretty sure I'm breathing in water.
I'm not happy about it, though.
There's a game of funk and
yeah, it's not water.
In my lungs.
That water's been through some people.
Some human body filters. I'm making some light work. Some 70% look like light work.
Yeah.
And then he does an up tilt under a platform.
All you need.
That's the foul grade.
Oh, can't be doing that.
Can't get it stuck in
time.
But he turned it around, shot him with a gun, and before you know it, he's about to get tech chased.
That's cool.
Kai's a genius. Kai's a fucking genius.
That seems like a Kai thing to do.
I would have never done that in my life. Double jab, SDI up, back air. Fucking genius, bro.
Yeah.
He's a dead genius now. Oh, no, he's not. He's a...
What? Oh.
It's loser semis. Brad's a loser. That's why he knows. To be fair, though, we're keeping it historically accurate here.
Yeah.
It is loser semis.
That's my bad.
Davin Mai versus Kai.
Tish Straddles. No, but the Coffee Rack Straddles was, right? I think.
I love Straddles.
Me too.
But he'd never get on the mic ever.
That's a good point.
He almost beat a Dr. Murray today.
Yeah. Yeah.
Ash is here. Ash, I miss you.
Me
Why
too.
Aren't you here? This is the one event I'm here, bro. Why aren't you here?
Are you coming to BAM, Ash?
Ash, come to BAM.
Come to BAM,
Ash. And bring your dog. It's really cute.
Yeah, true. I think there's a double zero calling your name.
Davin is winning. Davin is about to begin.
Take the other way around.
What do you mean? There's no way Kai get. There's no way a foul pick could die at 32.
Ah, it's sick. It's the back throw neutral there. Unstop it. I'll come in winter.
What's that?
I don't like
Why?
That.
Why? Oh, right. The game of funks. That makes sense.
Yeah, fair enough.
I don't blame you for that.
It's a bit stinky.
Davin.
Is that a kick?
Yeah, sort of. At 77%, that's more of an edge.
Yeah, fair enough.
When's BAM? It's 2 months.
Yeah, something like
be
that.
There or be square, Ash. You don't have an option. You fucking square. What? Ash, we're hitting the cash together. You and me. We're going big.
Yeah.
Ash, I'll bring a suit. I'll bring a suit and we'll go to the cast together.
The crown is calling our name.
You and me are gonna run that crown. I don't drink or gamble.
Oh. I don't drink my ass.
That, yeah, okay, you're just a blatant liar now, Ash.
I respect it though. Good work. Crowd.
Davin, really not doing a tech chase there. Just jabbing at air. Who do you think he was hitting? Wispy?
Oh, that was a textbook miss. Come on, David boy.
Power shield. Do you reckon he has one of those clicky shoulder buttons to help you power shield?
Yeah, sort of a game sort of move.
I think you do.
Yeah. Real game of hours.
Why would he down smash there? Yeah. I guess he knows something I don't.
Nah, I believe you, Josh. Don't worry about it. 100%.
I'm shield grabbing this.
He might fuck up.
Yeah, he probably will. Just like that. Davin sneaks
this
a game
one. I have no idea.
Yes.
Let's give him...
We'll just click up on the arrow. Click up on the arrow. Noob.
Okay.
I didn't come today because I'm too hungover. Yeah, shut up. We're already on the beers, Ash. You can't be too hungover to drink. Ooh.
Whoa.
Daft like, Fox.
Is this a, like, FB thing or a disrespect thing?
I bet it's an FB thing.
Yeah. Where'd you go, Ash? The fringe or...?
Kai's got nasty sick and shame combos. I would have done it back a week back out there, and I would have not continued my combo. Actually, I would have. Take notes, Kai. He knows infinitely more about Calvo than I do.
It's not fun if you know too much.
Yeah, I know. I feel like once you learn the frame data of the game, the fun disappears. And that's when the real winners of the game tell you opposite, but ignorance is bliss, right?
Yeah. Just go forward, hit the buttons. Hi-ya! Go, Davin, get a grab. Woohoo! Called it.
Davin. I'm not sure if I'm liking this Fox. Alright, that's a given. Yeah.
I don't mind it.
Good Fox! If Davin gets a grab right about now.
Yeah, that helps.
The thing is, he's gonna jump. This guy's gonna jump. Yeah. You know he's gonna jump. Filthy jumper.
He's going for it.
Yeah, he's really trying. But that's unfortunately what everybody in the world is thinking Fox is gonna try and do.
Yeah.
Either. Run up grab or run up smash, and you can beat both of those if you know what's happening. There's my melee knowledge for the day. You're welcome.
Ah, goes up and just assassinates him with the gun.
All of you have to pay me for coaching now. Oh my. Kai's making a mockery of DeFox.
His counterpick is not working super shot.
Yeah, he's just making a mockery of DeFox. Kai's used to playing Musky on this stage. Let's just put it that way.
Yeah.
There's one somebody who has a punished game on FD.
Oh my god.
His name's Muscat.
Yeah.
That's the first competitive melee game I ever played was Falco Fox on FD against Muscat. And he did not.
I think Maya was shooting Bowser against Ruben and he won. I think he knew I was alright, so Musket, he could, like...
Musket just straight up, like, completely force-docked me. I barely touched him. Chain
oh,
no,
that was Dr. Mario, but still. I think the Bowser was the next tournament. It was pretty funny, though. Shout out to Donut.
Shout out to Donut. There's a mosquito in this room. It's annoying me a fair bit.
Dude, we're
going to
get encephalitis.
Is that the Japanese thing?
Yeah, we're screwed.
Mission complete. Tied games. I might jump off of commentary now.
I'm so hungry.
Yeah, look, I'm not going to lie. I'm going to pass the J to someone else.
Do they have friends?
Anyone want to hop on comms?
Okay, guys, don't worry. Muscat's coming on comms now.
Let's go, Muscat.
Muscat's... Come on, comms. You're going to be joined by Nate.
I'll stay. We're good.
Hello, this is Muscat reporting in.
Tell me about the frame data then, Musty.
The frame data. Yeah, I don't know. Muscular doesn't know about frame data.
Yeah, he's got like the app on his like iPad.
Does he actually?
Yeah, it looks like shit up.
Yeah, alright, there you go.
I remember asking about it, and like I was like, how do I do this? He like gets the Smash Bros post up, there you go.
Yeah, I mean, I've got an iPad, all the frame data on it. Needed if I ever need to know what frame Fox's shine needs to come out on.
Yeah. I think I asked about like the chain grab and showed me and said fuck it up, but he tried.
And this is crazy. So Davin gave away a free game, but
yeah, I wasn't really convinced by that personally, but he gave it a good crack, I guess.
He gave it a crack.
I don't know, I didn't think it was like, I mean, I have no idea, but the Sheik's looking good.
The Sheik's looking good and he should stick with it. Fox is not clean.
Especially when like, Kai's played Musky 1,000 times.
Yeah. Oh my, doesn't even connect to that combo. Alright, finally dead.
Yeah, down smash is rough.
Good tomahawk.
He likes those.
Oh my god, and he gets burned. Yeah, it's good, they want that grab.
I don't know, Dav looks like so in control, but I guess Kai is getting some good damage off. Like, not in this game, I guess, but...
Well, you know, that's a good, like, 70. Yeah. Or, like, 50 or whatever you got there. Yep, can't be doing those. Diving real quick on those nairs.
Kai likes those platties.
He's chilling.
Cringe,
yeah. Who would platform camp someone? That's fucking shit off the blue.
Press W, boys, come on.
Yeah.
Good game's a good game.
I would never do that. Davin's gonna take this lead and throw it in the garbage can.
That was
the worst. He was on the other side of battlefield and just died.
I really think
if
he shielded that, he'd get a lot of damage. We just died, yeah.
There we go. Oh, good SDI.
Yeah.
Damage should be crouch tech, Jason, anyway. Nice read.
He's got under control.
Oh.
I already thought he was going to do that down.
He landed on the side platform.
Yeah, right.
Oh, that jab!
Yeah, that's cool.
He jabs me out there, B. Sucked in.
All under control.
2-1. Oh, David Nangs.
The one and only.
David Nangs is up 2-1. What is your Twitter?
That was it.
That's not it.
Yeah, it was. Deleted it.
Is it actual?
Yeah.
Is it Jeff with Jack? Yeah, there it is. True.
It's the OG.
I didn't know that. Oh man, I did know that.
You definitely did know that.
Yeah. I just saw Jeff and I thought he's the actual guy called Jeff.
I did it
here.
Before, it was cool.
Yeah. Oh my god. The movement.
I remember calling myself Jeff at that like Rocket League tournament. The guy that's the tallest thing to eat ever. I'm like, nah, it's not my name. Don't worry, it's funny.
Don't worry, it's funny. Trust me.
Yeah.
You went to a Rocket League tournament?
Are you like... You were there.
Oh, shit, yeah.
You're right there?
Well, that's not a Rocket League tournament. That's going to the pub they have Rocket League.
Yeah, well, there was a bracket and we played Rocket League.
There was a bracket.
And there was a prize. It was bigger than this.
It was a case of beers.
It was a case and half of beers, because you got the half, but Donut got the whole case, right?
I don't know, I got owned immediately.
Oh, okay, then maybe Someone got the half. Bailey, I think.
I think Donut got half the beers.
Yeah.
But then again, you're playing on like a Nintendo Switch.
On this really
laggy screen.
I wasn't a fan of it. It was a bit of fun.
I did not know the controls in the Nintendo Switch controllers. Let alone half the fucking... those little fucking... You know the half of the Nintendo Switch controller? Yeah.
Yeah.
That sucks.
Oh, the Joy-Con thing.
Yeah, the one Joy-Con. That was cooked. I got absolutely roped.
Yeah.
Then there's people bring their own PlayStation controllers, and it's like, this is nuts.
They're in for the beers.
Lucky Donut was somewhat good at that game, though.
Yeah. He was all talk and almost lost.
Well, he is ranked the highest league in Rocket League.
Yeah. I get the lag chance, but he should be stomping there, I reckon.
Yeah. There were some other nerds there, though.
True.
Like us.
They should do that. Should go back.
Yeah.
For a COVID thing, I don't know. Just with the controller and stuff.
I mean, I've been there. They do have games there, but I don't think they're doing, like, any controller stuff.
I went to the TA2s, like, a couple of times.
Oh, my God, that's big.
Oh, and the, after netball on Sundays, they have the, like, the $10 Korean fried chicken. Oh, man.
Is that good?
It's so good. Well, it's like $10, who cares, but it is really good.
So you can do a fucking shine after the down smash there, and the Sheik just goes flying to the... you know, to the side of the stage because of the knockback stacking.
Oh, and like with the down angle.
Yeah. So that you down smash, they answer tech, and then you shine them, and they'll just fly off the side.
That's pretty cool.
It's pretty funny.
Come on, Davin, we're hungry.
Come on, Davin. Oh no, Kai! No, Kai gets it done, I reckon. Kai gets it done.
I reckon Davin takes the stock and gets the cheese. That's my prediction.
Yep. Nice.
Oh. Back air, surely.
The funny thing is, like, those needles were only covering to angle to ledge and it still went for it. Oh, nice. Oh my god. Picks it up.
For that.
Yeah, thank god. He's panicking there.
Yeah, back air, neutral air, don't worry about it. Back throw, neutral air, I mean.
Yeah.
Whoa, that was a
thank you, Grab. Come on, bad area on shield in the corner, let's do it.
David's fishing for it.
Oh, here we go, tech chest then. Oh my, he's reading it.
The double. Oh, oh. So close for that.
Oh, it misses! Full hop back air, not the play. 2-2.
Go Fox, Davin, you won't.
This is sucks because bars close at 10 o'clock on a Sunday in Adelaide. It's fucked up.
I'm so hungry. So again, point that out if you care.
Yeah. Food places close at 9.
I got my full-time job now. I can't be out hanging around too long anymore, you know?
Yeah, you can.
No, fair enough. I like a Mawson leg, this shit.
You'll be fine.
Okay.
You got it.
Yep. Now you mention it.
You'll be alright.
Yeah.
It's not like engineering takes any critical thinking anyway.
Yeah. True. Got some downtime tomorrow, probably.
Yeah.
I'll make some downtime.
Davin moving now.
Yeah.
Keep him in the corner.
He's done with this.
Just really want this to end. We should get more sushi. First of all, we never should have gone to the sushi place.
Yeah, that was Brad's fault.
Mate, everything on the... it was just about to close, and everything on the fucking train had done, like, at least 50 rotations.
I didn't want to, like, order anything. I feel bad, so...
Yeah.
Yeah.
We should have,
Yeah.
And there was, like, stuff that I wanted, they were on the train, but like I know it had just been sitting there a long time, so I wasn't keen.
Yeah, like some of the sashimi stuff, it's like that seems scary because it's been vibing there.
I'm just like, yeah, like we're the only people in there.
What's the food plan for tonight?
God knows. It looks like it's gonna be a fucking a burger box, honestly.
Yeah. I'm opposed to that. Is it even open? Oh, I guess the Hindley Street one, yeah.
Yeah, the Hindley Street. It's definitely a Hindley Street. Fine.
He's got the reeds. Oh, sick. Davin's done with this.
Yeah, he's gonna play it up. But I don't know. I don't like the up air from Kai.
I think it doesn't even do much.
Yeah, it's fuck all. Yeah, do more of that. Nice. Oh my god, covered everything. Insane. On the platform.
Oh man, Kai wants it now.
As we say that.
Yeah, all right,
he gets a good ledgy.
Oopsie. Just grab.
Is Davin choking? Davin's surely not a choker.
He wouldn't.
Davin kind of is a choker.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, he's definitely more of a game 5 winner though. He likes those.
Ah, oh, that's it.
Yeah, that's clean.
Can't believe he didn't roll there, but good on him.
Good on Davin.
Well done to David Nangs. David cool. Nangs.
Oh my god, it's not even finals, bruh.
Oh, what do we got? We got, Davin versus Muscat. Davin can beat Sock, but he cannot beat Muscat.
Yeah, that's like, we were talking about this earlier, like, Muscat can beat everyone here, but then...
You mean Davin?
Well, as in like McLeod and Davin both beat Sock, but then Muscat just beats both of them.
Yeah.
And I don't think Muscat's been Sock.
I know Davin really wanted the dub on the Melbourne weekend.
Yeah.
Looks like it's going to be a Sheik game. Not going to be the Fox.
Yeah, that's good. Well, did he play Fox in the first set?
Yeah.
Interesting.
He played it on FD against Kai.
Oh, like...
No, in the first set he got 3-0'd by Muscat.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I still wear that. It seemed pretty clean. Big stage.
Good one to start. Oh my god, up air trains. I don't know, Muscat.
He's in control.
The man is consistent.
Yeah.
Like Davin's just going for so many reads tonight, and usually he just rolls with tech chases. Oh,
yeah,
I always forget how far that up air goes. He goes so far.
Just one grab.
Ooh, doesn't turn around. This might be it.
I feel like Kyle is definitely taking a place quite a lot. As long as he doesn't do that, it's great.
Like, how many reads? Yeah, how many bloody reads he's gone for?
Yeah. It's weird with Sheik, it's like, if you play, like...
Nice.
If you just win the whole tech chasing thing, if you just do a couple, you always could technically do it, right? So it's like...
What was that?
If you, like, tech chase with Sheik, like, if you play Sheik, you could technically always just... get every, like, reaction, right?
Yeah, you should.
but you have to be like,
oh yeah,
you know, you have to get it. It's hard to be consistent.
Yeah, yeah.
But Davin's definitely capable, and
yeah, yeah.
Seems like he just can't be bothered tonight.
Fair enough.
He's like, yeah. Today I'm going for eats.
That's not gonna smash it, why not?
Fucking hell, that one was cute. Also, Davin probably wasn't trying in the inner set. So
yeah. Classic Davin sandbag, yeah.
He might be trying now, so.
Wait till game three.
That roll doing wonders for Musky there. Oh, let's him land. Oh my god!
That's good STI.
That's some deco shit.
Damn, David is actually trying now.
Yeah, he did.
Hang it up.
Alright. Musket's so... He's just keeping the pressure on. Yep, nice. Nice. Ready for it. I saw Sock do the exact same thing to Davin in Melbourne a couple weeks ago.
I think they like, know that Davin always hits those. They're ready for it.
Davin doesn't miss him.
He did that like new age slide up stuff.
Yeah.
Oh, the reads.
Yep. See, now he's reacting.
Yeah.
Oh, missed the easy part. That's it. Roll. Good shit.
Three-oh.
I think everyone here is wanting a 3-0. Daily cheering so hard for Muscat right now.
He wants a 3-1.
Ah, Jasper, how are we, sir?
How's it going?
My god, that was a sick up tilt. Alright. Just the fair and chicken grabs.
That seemed like a uncharacteristic miss, but anyway.
Which one?
Like bogging the needle.
Yeah, I don't know, the needle's...
They're not on time, I don't know.
They're all over the place.
Yeah.
Alright, that
There we go.
Yeah. So the thing is, even if you get the soft back air, it just sends them the terrible angle.
Yeah.
Just get the kill anyway. Same move.
It's
same. Yeah, same thing when you don't GI the up throw. Sorry. He's banging the mic. Oh, he keeps extending it. That's good. That might just do it. Okay.
That soft back air is so depressing. Like 100% doesn't do anything.
Yeah.
It's enough though.
It's enough. Sends him at a good enough angle.
Yeah.
Alright.
Whoa.
I was like, yeah, please grab that. He took his time. And he got it. Fucking hell. That's good. You don't want
to. All reactions.
Look, Jasper's taking a shit and having a good time. You don't want to be having a bad time though while taking a shit. That's not good. Oh my. Swag it out! Fuck!
Either.
He can't finish his food. Alright. Slow get up. Does it for him.
It's like you don't get like 3-0s from one person to 3-0 the other person very often. I might be calling it too soon, but that was not in control.
No, I think that's a fair call.
I think of all people, though, Devin would be the one.
Yeah.
Absolute weapon when he wants to be. Ready, go! Oh, a bit awkward there.
Alright. Just chilling in the corner. The stage is fucking hard for Sheik.
Yeah.
Alright, but getting the tech chase going.
Those like down air strings are pretty cool though.
Yeah.
I assume there's like pretty specific percent of that and stuff.
Alright, down air? Okay. Need like a down two or a forward two there, I reckon. Not quick enough to do the down air. But yeah. That was bloody good. He's gonna clean it up.
But just had it in control. Four spot dodges. Cool.
Alright. Just gets a cheeky down to it in, keeps it going.
Oh, sick.
Alright. What can he do here? You know, he just dash attacks out of the corner and he's fucking him up for it. That's insane.
Whoa,
don't
careful.
Kill yourself. Oh, is he gonna hit Shine Spike? Get him! You dumbass!
No.
That is tilting. McLeod's always on the box, Sash.
Yep.
He's a new man, a rectangle gamer. Oh, no.
He's a real gamer.
Yeah. Oh, what a grab! Doesn't quite kill for it. Oh!
Oh, man. FD. Has to come down.
FD, yeah. What goes up has to come down. Oh!
That
is so strong. I'm still not used to that NTSC up smash.
Yeah. It's good they knew where they went to go for it. If he didn't, it would have been like...
Yeah. I don't know. I don't know. Davin had that knowledge. Oh, that's huge. Oh, and he does a snap to ledge. And he doesn't do it again. Oh, must be going clutch mode.
Oh, no. That's the FD game out the way.
Everyone's cheering, but deep down inside, they're just like, fuck, I want this to be over.
Yeah. That was a
but,
game,
yeah, I like the fire being brought out in Muscat.
Yeah. He wants this big W. Not convinced he's going to get it, but he's got some good stuff going. I'm just not convinced.
No way, the tech traps are numerous.
That's cool.
Bloody hell.
Okay, stay on the stage. Good work. No time to be down there.
No time to be down there. It literally cost him a set.
Yeah, it did.
I mean, yeah, we just add a hint of
musky
clutchness. Davin's like, please pop up. Stop staying on the ground. Ledge? Nah, bloody.
Nice.
Yeah, honestly, taking the back air is just better at this point.
Yeah. I don't think he would have died. Oh, yeah. Oops. Did he even change the...
What is it?
Loser's final?
Oh, yeah. Here? It's up the top. No, not that far up.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Keeping us honest. It is not, in fact, loser's semis.
Thanks, Ash.
Ash, wanting the best out of everyone. A real self-motivator.
There's a few vocal critics of the commentary and the non-commentating scores of the crowd.
Yeah, in-person critics, who would have thought? Oh, that was a cool chill and shine. All right, cleans it up. Oh, he's got another chance. Dead ledge. Davin Yu. What else are you going to do? All right, I don't know how Musk is going to come back from here, but that's a good start. Bailey yelling it starts like that. It does, in fact, start like that. Let's go, Musket. You can be clutch right now. You got to do it. Shoot those lasers.
Get a drill.
All right, don't do that. Yes. Oh. Missed the reaction. That was he missed the dash back.
Davin scared.
Oh, no. He's got another shot.
Got a load. Davin chokes. Can't be going down there.
I try to conjure it into existence, but
that's good.
Good on
him.
All right, we got GFs coming up.
Both of them. Oh, Bailey, you want this?
Yeah, we need...
Huh? You want the thing? Yeah, you do.
We're like grand finals now. Whoa.
Muscat, would you like the microphone?
Whoa, dude. We got South Australian Nicholas. Let's go.
Let's get some real damage.
Jasper says he wants you on. Yeah. Jasper continues to have the gift of the gab through.
I fucking love you, cunt.
He continues to have the gift of the gab through Twitch chat, which is a rare thing. He's not coming on though. Good try.
He's not.
Bailey. I'm talking to the chat. SA Nick. You're right, I forgot the I forgot the exclamation point in there. Thank you for that one, Brad. Nick has good pivot skills.
He does.
It had been proven. Oh fuck, his pivots are good. Shit. This guy's
What's
dangerous.
What's Davin gonna do?
He's in winner's side for a reason. David Ayings needs a fat L next to his name. Not because he's
in
losers, because he got styled on. Alright.
I just realized what the pot. God, I honestly call that auto mod racist.
Yeah. Love you, cunt. Also, fuck you, cunt. We can see it. Oh, don't worry. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Allow it.
We gotta allow it. There we go.
Yeah.
This is an Australian stream.
Yeah.
Oh, God. Oh, already stuck down. I wonder how much of the puff we're gonna see in these two games if he starts losing. This might be a long two sets. Potentially.
Oh, fuck yeah. Let's go, Nick!
Woo!
Pick it up. Do a pivot. Not like that. That's not how you pivot.
That's like he's never seen a sheik before.
Oh my god. He's getting styled on. Oh my god.
Oh,
Nick rolling his eyes.
Big eye roll right there. Oh, I'm grabbing twice in place.
Oh
Nick gonna have to wake up. Nick may
He's
be
sleeping.
Thinking the tournament, maybe just falling asleep after Muzcat going, just I've got this.
Alright, that's way to get the blood pumping, the adrenaline going.
Yep. Maybe you need some Kai jumping jacks off the set.
Kai jumping jacks?
Yeah, like, just like does a jumping. I beat him game one and he just jumping jacked in front of
yeah,
me.
Yeah, I don't like that. I want to get back into the match.
Yeah, and I'm just like, can we play? And he's like,
yeah, and he's like, oh, okay, yeah, you got to get your exercise in real quick. Fair
I'm
play.
I'm just like, you just got me. I'm just like, I don't understand.
And it's like, damn, doing. Like his strategy's working. I want to play and I can't. And now I'm angry. And I'm losing the set and I'm angry.
Oh,
this
boy.
Sucks.
Oh.
Yeah, no.
You bring it back, though. Oh, greedy F tilt.
Oh my god.
He's slicing.
Nick's turning it on.
Nick?
Honestly, probably one of the slowest starters in Australia.
He's a slow starter. Except for the fact that he like got good in 11 months or whatever.
Yeah. I mean, like, just like in sets. Like game, like the first half of game one, the first game. Sometimes game one, sometimes game two. But as soon as it hits like game three, four, five, he's just a different man.
That's true. He did get four stuffed against Spud once. And then won.
And then he won.
And then he won.
It's insane.
Don't forget it. This guy's a BAM champion.
Maybe another BAM champion this year with, what was it, BAM 12 coming up?
I don't know.
Something like that.
BAM 2022.
Finally, maybe.
Oh my god. Ooh. He's doing a combo. Oh, the Moth Ford is so scary. Oh, he's grounded.
Davin doing
as if he dash attacks there.
He's been just like tilting and dash attacking a lot of shields so far. Yeah. Just like lazy bear into tilt.
Do a boost grab, please, like that. Except for his. Oh my.
Oh, he's got no jump. He's still got side B. Oh, actually, neutral B was really smart there. Because I would have read side B.
That might be off the side. He's got a jump.
Does he transform? No. I guess it's just one kick. Is that it?
Fucking
wow, okay.
Great choice.
that was a really good choice. Let's go, Nick. If you win, we get food. At his house.
SA Nick was saying he wants to win the quickest way possible.
That's not Puff.
That is not Puff. Or maybe he said the easiest way possible.
That is probably... I don't know.
It's probably still not Puff.
It's probably still not Puff either.
I hope Nick realizes that.
I think Davin might have gone Yoshi's. Oh,
let's go.
Specifically because he's worried of the Puff.
Yeah.
Which, that's good. Like, because I've made that...
Mental conditioning.
Oh. When you get to keep your... Like, you don't even have to play your worst counter pick because of your secondary.
Yeah.
Small amount. Even though I think Davin did lose that game. That was the one game he lost to Nick, I think.
Oh my god. Uh-oh, this is looking dangerous for Davin.
Nick's just popping off.
Oh my god, up B? He wanted it.
Nick's been so good at coming down. So
far. Oh, what is going on? He's on the platform, he's not on the platform.
Davin just doing a lot of moves that hope Nick isn't holding the L button, and Nick just holding the L button.
Yeah, Davin ducking under the rising forward airs, and then doing nothing.
Yep.
Oh, Davi's still. That's good.
Whoa.
Oh.
Just a little antsy.
What's he going to do here?
Up tilt the other way, and it kills.
That's
okay.
the best up tilt hitbox. That is the best one. Sends them into the shadow realm, some would say.
That move has so many hitboxes. I don't even know what I'm going to hit by half the time. I'm just like, oh, I guess it sent me that way. Ooh. Oh,
that was a grab.
I think it wasn't actually, because he didn't fast fall the nair, so I think he was going to land behind the shield. So it was actually good he didn't buy on that.
Okay, maybe. Ooh, not long enough. Increase the sword range.
Yeah, it just needs to be longer.
It's not longer.
Oh,
no
good, really.
Oh
good
my god, that up B has been paying the dividends.
Yeah, just a greedy nair, to be honest.
Another greedy B as well. What? What happened there? That was like a phantom sour spot.
Oh no, please cover it. Yeah, okay. I miss Bailey in the crowd so much.
Yeah.
It's beautiful.
It's what we need.
It is.
Actually, we've got a fair bit of a crowd going.
We do?
There's a crowd cam.
At a 13-man tournament. That's crazy in South Australia.
30-man tournament? 10-person crowd. If you don't include us and the players. So 14 people watching.
Damn.
Including David and Nick.
This might be a quick throw. Is he going to take him to Dreamland? Are we going to have a very painful... No. Yeah, back to Yoshi's. Okay.
Yeah, no. Davin's a man of the people. He's not going to... He's not a good subject.
Oh.
If there's anyone I know who wants to get 3-0'd more than the crowd, it's Davin.
It'd be hard to do it one and more than the crowd, I'll be honest. They get pretty vocal about it.
Dodges it.
Oh, I hate that nair. I really hate that nair. Just not covering anything.
Oh!
There we go. That was a really good tech.
It's over for John. It's over for Gorilla Boy.
It's such a nuts tech.
Oh! I don't know, that just looked violent, that F smash.
Because it hit like the needles, and then Sheik just does the most just grotesque scream.
Yeah. And also, he's trying to arms attack it, so.
Yeah. So, holding all the way out.
I don't think it works on the Yoshi slant, does it?
No idea.
Yeah. Well, he tried to do it and it didn't work, so that's all the proof I need.
This is real science.
Oh my!
Still facing the wrong way. Needs to be facing backwards whenever he goes for that edge guard. He's just facing forward and either doing like nair or just giving up ledge.
Whoa! He just went down really quick. He's an elevator, bro.
And when he went up, he just like went on the stage.
That's a spirit animal.
Oh!
Crazy.
That was actually insane. I think he like tried to wave dash out and just held down.
He's so teasing. Smart. He knows. Oh my god.
Oh, the phantom on tilt.
There's been a few phantoms today.
Oh, the second needles is really smart though. And that's a whole 58.
Davin is trying now though.
Oh. Dude, when Sheik wants to put on the damage, she just like does random 60%.
Davin started to try.
Oh
my god,
elbow.
Nick. You weren't ready for Davin trying. Fucking hell, mate.
Davin definitely a man to pick his moments. Or is like, he's, I'm gonna.
Davin's like, actually, I've decided I don't want to be 3-0 anymore.
He's like, I would just, you know what? I feel like playing 40% better. And you're like, damn, he really just did play 40% better. I didn't expect this.
Nick doing the rising forward air to like fuck up the DI of the arms attack.
Yeah.
Oh my god, he doesn't arms attack on this crowd though. Oh my. What's he doing? Oh no. He's
moving all the way around him. Oh, he got the grab though.
Yeah. Back throw?
Down
throw.
Throw and then tech chase. That's it.
Yeah, nice. No.
All right,
I thought he would be confident enough.
2-1.
My guess was that he would be scared.
Yep.
No, but he's trying now, so.
He has his confidence.
He was.
What, just ducks under the man. Sheik's like just like a snake. She just goes down and up and just like compresses herself into like a millimeter, and you're like, damn.
But unlike for no reason. Yeah, unlike a snake, she has limbs, and they're very annoying.
Yeah, I really wish she didn't have those feet in the shop.
I'll be happy if Sheik is just a stump, but. It'd be
a weird image in my head.
Easy money for me, mate.
Oh, the juggle. Nick doing good at both the juggle and not getting juggled, which is probably like half as much, I don't know. Oh, slide off. Doesn't get a follow up. I feel like you have to know the slide off's going.
Oh, it doesn't reverse it. Lazy.
Ooh, she'll work. And a kill as well. Sheik now really strong.
Alright,
Kai, I wish you the best in your adventure.
Yeah.
Hopefully, fingers crossed, no ticket.
Yeah, no ticket. Let's go. So, yeah, shout outs to Monty Python.
Oh, that was a good recovery, actually. He's really good at getting the little shorts on stage, and they're hard to cover. Oh.
He needs to be doing more of that.
Yeah.
He gets a grab?
He tilted that shield like 10 times this set, and he's finally grabbing.
Yeah.
Maybe he was just all in Nick's head the whole time.
Yeah. Multi-game conditioning.
Just like, I will be stupid for 3 games and now I will try, and you're not going to be ready for it. also Nick's thing sometimes. Where you're just like, wow, this guy is just like not really doing much, and then he reads everything.
He's like, damn, he's paying attention. Damn it.
Can't get away with my garbage.
Yeah. Alright, ties up the stocks. Let's see what Davin can do. Not to fall victim.
Oh, that was a good movement.
Oh, why is he charging a needle? Come on, mate.
Feels so dangerous.
Get it together! Alright, let's go. If David names as he loses, and you can tell by the fat L next to his name.
I love David names.
Yeah. Oh, good recovery. Oh my god, he's racking it up.
This could be food time.
Stacking it up.
I'm proud of you, Gunk.
What?
No.
I don't know, what do you do there? Wave dash on grab?
Yeah, I guess it's just a 50-50 where you're like, if he air dodges, you just have to go early.
Can you like react to the air dodge like a ledge dash grab?
You probably could. Yeah. I imagine the best Marth can do is...
That's it.
Nick, 3-1. Clean sweeping. I think he dropped one game this tournament.
Yeah.
Good to have him back. Good to have all the boys here.
Good to have all the boys.
Oh. All right, don't know what the plan is.
Oh, I think...
Does Nick want an interview?
Yeah, maybe Nick wants an interview. Who knows?
Nick, do you want to talk to the people?
Oh, no, he seems pretty 50-50.
He's
I know he likes to chat. I know he likes to have a chat. He's just going to shake everyone's hand in the crowd first, so don't worry.
All Nick. Right.
Just,
he's still going.
No, he's got to get the handshakes in. Don't worry.
Hey, Jeff. All right, looks like...
Yeah, what's the full screen one of us? Here we are.
I'll just grab Nick.
Nangs, that is not OD. I don't know.
Nicholas,
Hi, Jasper. I love you.
I think he's gone, man.
It's tough getting berated like that.
Berated.
You know, it's sad. It's a sad state of affairs when you have to sit there with your fellow competitor who you're a good friend with and listen to the nonsense that was coming out of Bailey.
Do you reckon that's what lost you that one game?
Well, that's probably what lost everyone any game in the set. I think it could have been a totally different set.
Oh, really?
Yeah, Bailey was going crazy. He's going cuckoo crazy.
He was. Do you reckon Davin tried that set or...
No, he probably lost on purpose. You're right.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I was saying, like, as soon as he got the game, I'm like, okay, he's starting to try, but.
Ah.
Yeah.
No. He actually was trying to lose to me.
All right. So what inspired you to come to an actual LAN?
Well, I wanted to try to lose to Davin.
I'm not as good as Davin.
So yeah. He's actually tried to lose to me
you're both sandbagging, that's right.
We're both just... Yeah, I mean, you can only try your best.
Yeah, that's right.
At the end of the day.
Well, I don't know why you're on the couch then. Get Davin over here.
That's true, actually. Yeah. You want me to get Davin?
Yeah, no, you stay here. I'll get Davin.
Davin, they want to do a winner's interview. Ruben wants to... Yeah.
Oh, okay, yeah, no, we'll do this. He took offense to that.
I don't know what you mean by winner's interview.
I'm just saying, like, you were both sandbagging and...
Yeah.
And
sure.
You just happened to do it better, so...
I won in that regard.
You are the master.
Nick is not going to be prepared for the next major.
No, he's not.
No one's prepared.
All right, well, I'm sure, since Nick's admitted that, I'm sure he's willing to give over... The petty, I don't know, $12 extra that he's won.
Mm-hmm.
Of course.
I'm kind of glad for the crowd that Nick didn't play Puff. He was definitely talking about it today. Before, when we both got here, he wanted to play Puff for the entire tournament. Yeah. And that would have definitely been a half an hour set.
Yeah, I think it would have just been Nick alone in this in the venue.
Pretty much. You can play my AI.
Yeah, we had a big crowd, so.
Today was amazing.
You did what was right.
Everyone in SA showed up.
Yeah, I know. It was good.
It was really cool to see. It's not often that we get everyone here.
Mm-hmm.
Usually one or two people are missing.
Everyone relevant.
Also, no, I am apparently...
Everyone's
I'm SA now. Relevant. Okay.
Yeah, SA.
I was ACT for a bit.
Yeah, I don't know what Kai's doing.
But SA for sure.
When's the next time you're going to ACT? Never, probably. Yeah, that's what I thought.
Not too wrong. Hey, maybe when I go to Phantom, we can do a road trip to ACT.
Road trip to ACT?
It's only 3 hours away.
Yeah, all right.
Not bad.
3 hours away.
Mm-hmm. Phantom
not
will
from
be fun.
South Australia.
No, definitely
when
not.
When is Phantom? That's in July, right?
It's in July, yeah.
Yep.
The next major is BAM in May.
Mm-hmm.
Everyone should go if you can, especially all you Victorian people.
Especially the South Australian people, even if you're shit. It's just a fun time.
Are you going to head off to BAM as well?
Yeah, absolutely.
Oh, really?
100%.
Ooh, that's tempting then. That's tempting. It should be a big tournament.
Yeah.
It should be fun. Having a major, finally. Or like an open major.
Yeah, that's right.
Ruben tempts you, huh?
Anyway, why are you going for so many reads today?
I just couldn't tech chase, to be honest.
Just hadn't got
my reactions were, yeah.
Yeah.
I didn't play for like 4 days before this, 3 days, I want to say.
Yeah.
And I just showed up and hoped for the best.
Yeah.
I could not react at all.
Okay, I see. Well, I think we're going to pack up here, so...
Fair enough. Hey, thanks for the commentary.
Yeah. I tried, man. I tried. I hope you guys put up with it. Anyway, congratulations. Biggest sandbagger in South Australia.
Thank you.
Let's go. All right. Thank you, everyone.
Do a proper handshake. There we go.
See everyone.
Ooh. Peace.
Hello, everyone. Thank you for watching the Cheese League March 2022. It's your boy, Kai. Hope you all had fun watching that one. It was a good time. I really appreciated having everyone in chat. Shout out to everyone who followed today. We had a few come through, which I'm very, very grateful for. Thank you for JNuts for hosting us earlier in the night. We actually cracked 2.4K followers tonight, so that's really cool. Really cool stat. So thanks for chilling with me. Next one, once again, will be the third Sunday of April. So the next one's going to be on the 17th of April. So if you want to watch some more South Australian Melee, tune into my channel then. As always, you can follow the stream to get informed of South Australian Melee content. You can follow all of our socials in chat. Follow my Twitter. I always tweet out when we go live with any events or any other random streams. Make sure to subscribe to the YouTube as well. YouTube.com/SASmashTV. All the VODs will go up there once this tournament's over. And you'll be able to watch it from start to finish. And have all the VODs cut up into matches as well. But thank you for watching, everyone. I'll go off and return the favor and host someone else now. Let's see if anyone is streaming Melee. If not, I'll send you somewhere else. And we will see. We'll see you next time, guys. So who's streaming Melee right now? Smash Finland has an event right now, apparently. Could host them off. Let's see who I'm following and who I want to host, though. You know what? We're hosting another Adelaidean, the Spud Hunter. He's playing some of the new game that came out, The Cycle Frontier. I hope you enjoy his stream. He's a bit of a clown. He's a bit of a fun time. Hope you enjoy watching him. Until next time, guys, this is Melee. Kaiser signing out. Love you lots. Bye-bye.